against Troy Calhoun, also in his sixth season. He is an Academy grad, setting an Academy record with a sixth consecutive bowl appearance. 10 former Falcons are on the Air Force coaching staff. Down to the field now, and the third member of our team, Lewis Johnson.
All right, Beth, thanks very much. And one of the biggest concerns for Air Force coming into this game would be the health of their senior quarterback, Connor Dietz. He's been dealing with slightly separated shoulders, both arms, throughout the season. He hasn't missed a game, but he's had to come out of several games. Now, I saw him before the game started their warm-ups, and I noticed some tape coming out on his shoulders on both sides. I asked him about that. He said, oh, it's only precautionary. Big smile on the face. And then I said, all right, where are you from 0 to 100%? And he said, of course, I'm 100%. But the way he's rolling those shoulders, it tells me... Remember, guys, as a game, but he's hoping if they do score a touchdown, he might get a little salute or two from some of his players.
They are, by the way, saluting some of their compatriots you see on the back of the jersey. One of the things about this bowl, of course, it's a big thank you to all our servicemen and women around the world. And instead of wearing the names on the back of the jersey, a shout out to the B-2 Spirit aircraft and the F-22 Raptor, all a part of the Air Force repertoire worldwide. Rice winning the toss and electing to receive. They want the football. They love the time of possession statistic. It's been in their favor all year long, and they will start out just across the 20-yard line. And Taylor McCarg is the junior quarterback out of Cedar Park, Texas. 11 passing touchdowns, 11 rushing touchdowns. And he was also plagued at midpoint in the season with a shoulder injury.
Been banged up a little bit. He is a guy that would like to pass first and then run second, but he's very capable to run and make big plays with his feet.
And they will head to the air. It's Ross coming out of the backfield. And a pickup of 4 on first down. Brian Lindsay with the tackle. Ross is the junior out of Schertz, Texas. Over 80 guys on this Rice roster. Homegrown talent from the Lone Star State. Ross trying to get to the outside, and good penetration coming on the edge. And a loss of 7 on the play. Austin Nicholas leading the charge, one of their top guys on defense.
And Air Force likes to move around on defense because they're not very big guys, so they're not going to overpower you. So what they do is they bring blitzes, they bring guys from different areas. Right there, very nice penetration for a loss. Sets up an early 3rd and long, which is what Air Force wants to do, try to get off the field here and give their offense good field position.
Back at their own 19, empty set here from a card. With 5 wideouts. Looking up the middle, and pressure coming from behind, and he's taken down for the loss. 10 yards in the wrong direction. Reggie Barnes is the guy that got to him.
And again, they bring a linebacker off the edge. And that's what you have to do with McCarg. You have to hit him. You have to keep him in the pocket. He's very athletic, can make plays with his feet. Keep him in the pocket. That's what 3rd and longs do to a quarterback, is he has to wait, let his receivers get downfield, and you can get after him with a set.
He was able to blow right by John Hody, and now Taylor Cook out of his own end zone to punt it here on 4th down with Ty MacArthur making the fair catch in Rice territory. And the Falcons set up nicely for 2nd Lieutenant Connor Dietz out of Columbus, Ohio, a recent graduate. And after the game today, he'll have a couple of months on leave, and then he will report for duty at MacDill Air Force Base down in Tampa, Florida. In his first season as a starter, getting the Falcons back to a bowl game. MacArthur is the motion man. I formation, the deep back and the I inside the 45-yard line is their 1,000-yard rusher, Cody Getz. There is Connor back on December 19th with his parents. And his teammates have been kidding with him with the occasional salute throughout the course of the last couple of weeks. It's a rarity, Joey, since they don't redshirt at the academy. Usually you get your 4 years and move on to your active duty. He had an injury that made it difficult for him to do schoolwork or any physical activities and had to miss a semester, and that's why he was back at school this fall. The pitch. And close to the first down is Dante Strickland, the senior out of Kansas City.
And of course, Air Force starts off with three straight runs, getting positive yards on first and second down, set up a third and five, which is offensively where they'd like to be. It allows them to get some yards and then have the option of going for it on fourth down, which you know they're going to do.
And here they go, almost four times per game, they will go for it on a fourth down. The most in the country. And on the fourth and one, they jump the gun.
And that is a rare penalty from Air Force.
False start. Offense, number 29, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
They are the least penalized team in the country as well, so the miscue there from Austin Brill.
Yeah, and it's rare that they shoot themselves in the foot. And in this situation, a fourth and short, which is in their wheelhouse, that's what they do. Now all of a sudden, you're punting the ball away, sort of giving up that good field position you started with.
Punting unit comes on instead here, David Baska. And the fair catch by Bryce Callahan at the 10. Bryce, the sophomore from Cypress, Texas, returning from an injury to play in the ball game. It's the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl here in Fort Worth.
Why do I like this new Buick Verano? It lets me audible.
OnStar, how can I help you?
Orange Barrel, reroute.
Sending new route now.
My bad.
Call Papa Bear. Hut, hut.
Hey, Peyton, just fired up the grill.
Tune XM60 Outlaw. If you don't know the innovative Verano, then you don't know Buick.
Don't wait for the new year to experience Buick. Lease this innovative Buick Verano with 2 years of scheduled maintenance for around $199 per month.
Buy one, get three is back at Joseph A. Bank. Buy any suit, sport coat, or outerwear. Get three more absolutely free, including signature suits, sport coats, and leather jackets. That's four for the price of one. Expand your wardrobe or split the deal with friends and family. Mix and match any suit, sport coat, or outerwear. Buy one, get three free now. Most stores open at 9 a.m. through Saturday at Joseph A. Bank.
The boys use Capital One Venture Miles for their annual football trip. That's double miles you can actually use. Tragically, their buddy got sacked by blackouts.
But it's our tradition.
That's roughing the cardholder.
But with the Capital One Venture card, you get double miles you can actually use.
Any fright? Any time.
Scoreboard doesn't lie.
What's in your wallet? Hut!
I have me on my fantasy team.
Tonight, it's a top 25 matchup between the number 23 Longhorns and the 13th-ranked Beavers. Capital One Bowl Week continues with the Valero Alamo Bowl. Tonight at 6:45 on ESPN. College football lives here.
Welcome to the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl. It is our honor and privilege to sponsor this great event. Bell Helicopter and the Textron family of companies have a long history of supporting our military. And today's game is dedicated to those men and women who have served our armed forces in the past and who are serving today around the world. Thank you all, and enjoy the game.
And just a moment ago, during the commercial, a moment of silence for Norman Schwarzkopf, who passed away a couple of days ago. General Schwarzkopf leading the U.S. coalition forces in Operation Desert Storm that liberated Kuwait back in 1991. He himself a graduate of the U.S. Military Academy at West Point, a decorated Vietnam vet, and certainly best known for leading the United States back in 1991 to liberate Kuwait. And back onto the field of play here at the Armed Forces Bowl. And a running play up the middle for Rice. Three and out in their first possession, and they actually had negative 14 yards. And a gain of six right there. Charles Ross on the carry. Charles had a few 100-yard rushing games on the season, including a career-high 154 yards against UTEP. By the way, you can see the red, white, and blue, the stars and bars inside the R on their helmet. Also a nod to the U.S. Troops serving worldwide. Ross picking up the first down out across the 20-yard line. Good block that time by Andrew Roya, and another six-yard pickup.
And this one, Rice is at their best when they can gain positive yards running the football, because it sets up later passes. It sets up their play action, which is what they want to get into.
Up to the 25, a short gain on first down. Corralled by Alex Means, the four-year starter at outside linebacker for Air Force. You don't have a lot of freshmen that can step right into the starting lineup at the academy. Now in his senior year. Short pickup on the pass play to Sam McGuffey, the senior out of Cypress, Texas, who started his career at the University of Michigan before coming back home.
McGuffey's their fastest wide out. He's the guy they'd like to go downfield to when they do look for a big play. Early on, the short pass, those always set up longer, bigger plays later on in the game, because defensive backs will start to creep up when they realize that the fast guy can catch the short routes.
Third and four on the last possession. The three-man rush was able to get to McCard. They'll bring five this time. McCard on the rollout, going to take it himself. Needing a block and getting one. Taking a big lick out across the 35-yard line. Christian Spears, the sophomore out of Grand Prairie, Texas, making the hit.
And this is what McCard does best here. Stands in the pocket, looks to pass. Nothing there. Then he can make the play with his feet. Coaches like him to get down, not take those kind of shots. He got banged up early in the season. Those kind of hits are the kind that mount up on a quarterback over a season. And then when he comes into a game, says, I'm 100%. Well, nobody's 100%, especially taking hits like that.
He tried a pitch to Ross. And again, it was Austin Nicholas, the senior out of Fullerton, California. He's showing us already, Joey, why he's the leading tackler on this team. Their third tackle for loss already in this first quarter.
It's important for Air Force, for Nicholas, for Chambers, for Alex Means, you know, their playmakers at linebackers. They have to make those kind of plays. They have to be good tacklers in open field and shut down this Rice rushing game and force them to be one-dimensional, force them into the longer passes. Here we have a second and long. Again, a passing down, and this is how Air Force got to him last time on passing downs.
Dexter Walker showing blitz off the right side. Here he comes. McCard just dumps it down into the turf. Charles Ross was close enough to it, so they won't elicit a flag there. Nick Fitzgerald, Brian Lindsay, as you mentioned, Joey, they're moving guys around. They're showing a lot of different looks, being very deceptive on offense to combat their lack of size.
And that's a second blitz off the right side that Coach Warren has sent. The defensive coordinator has sent a blitz and got to the quarterback, Rush McCard, out of the pocket, sacked him the first time, that time rushed him into getting rid of the ball. So the blitz is working well on passing downs for Air Force so far.
One of two on third down so far today. McCard stepping up, a flag down, and now the quarterback is down. Alex Means, the senior out of Mankato, Minnesota, got there. A couple of sacks already for this Air Force defense. They only had 15 all year.
Illegal formation on the offense. Number 74 is not on the line of scrimmage. That penalty is declined. Fourth down.
And this is the third or fourth different guy the Air Force has had at defensive end on passing downs. Means here, the linebacker, maybe the most athletic linebacker, does a little bit of everything, has a few sacks, has a couple interceptions, 89 tackles on the season. He's a mismatch for any offensive tackle. And you can see his speed and athleticism gets around the corner and gets a hit on the quarterback.
Defensive coordinator Charlton Warren doing a nice job moving folks around, and another punt headed towards MacArthur, and another fair catch from Ty at his own 31-yard line. A 34-yard punt here in Fort Worth, where every day they still roll the cattle up the old Chisholm Trail.
at ProjectLuna.com.
It's a 315 horsepower, 5.3 liter V8 Nutcracker. The 2013 GMC Sierra. Get 0% financing for 60 months, plus trade up to this specially equipped Sierra and use your $2,000 package discount for a total value of $4,000. Or choose to trade up with customer cash and your $2,000 package discount for a total value of $7,500.
Red Lobster is surprising real people with our new 15 under 15 menu.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my gosh, this looks amazing.
15 entrees under $15. It's our new mainstays, like chicken with wine sauce or bacon wrapped shrimp. Try 15 under 15 and see food differently.
Do you know what my favorite run of the day is?
The last one?
Yeah, it's a big mess. But don't worry, cleanup's already underway.
When the things that matter most are on the line, make sure we are too. The disaster recovery team at 1-800-SERV-PRO. Like it never even happened.
ESPN College Football, the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl, is brought to you by Bell Helicopter, on a mission to support America's warfighters. ProjectLuna.com and the Experience Buick Lease. It's a new lease on luxury.
Well, current day, it's an entertainment and shopping venue, but when it opened up back after the Civil War, the Fort Worth Stockyards, the perfect convergence of cattle and railroads, making its way across the United States. And this was one of the main pickup points for the Longhorn cattle. And the Air Force Academy, with its second possession, they've had all running plays thus far. And of course, the big hit for them was the false start on fourth and one that forced them to punt it away in their first possession.
If you're Rice defense, this is what you want from Air Force offense. Force them into a second and long and to a third and long.
They'll give it to the fullback, Wes Cobb, the senior out of Houston, Texas, and a pickup of seven. One of the things that Troy Calhoun has done is brought a little no huddle to the Air Force Academy. All running plays, which is no surprise to this point. They actually had a game this year against Hawaii where they did not throw the ball, not once. Picked up a 21-7 win on that day. The keeper for the quarterback and a big gainer into Rice territory goes Connor Dietz to the Owls 46 and a 17-yard scamper.
Looks like a little confusion. Play a little confusion on offense here. It looks like Dietz and the running back are on different pages here, but Dietz, being such a good athlete, has the ability, play is broken down, athletic enough to still gain yards and turn into a big play, probably their biggest gain of the day so far.
Connor Dietz taking over for the four-year starter, Tim Jefferson, in his first year as the signal caller. And the ball pops loose and a turnover forced by the Rice defense.
Turnovers have been a problem for Air Force this season. In the past 5 years, they've gotten worse as their season's gone on with turnovers. Here's a big one early in the game. You know, Rice was having problems stopping the run on this drive, and now all of a sudden the turnover. Big play for Rice and his defense, and if they're going to shut down this Air Force offense, they're going to have to force turnovers to help their offense get the shorter fields.
Jared Williams, falling down, was able to lean in and poke the ball loose as Paul Porras hung on to John Lee. And Joey, you alluded to it. Both Troy Calhoun and offensive coordinator Clay Hendricks said job number one is to take care of the football today. And Air Force doesn't do it right there, but their defense so far is the story of this game. Austin Nicholas is all over the field. They have been accustomed to taking very good care of the football, but in the last few years, headed in the wrong direction. This season, 109th in turnover margin in FBS play.
Which is strange for a team that leads the country in the least amount of penalties. So they're pretty good at not shooting themselves in the foot, but they turn the football over. You know, the two things just don't go together.
five tackles for loss now for this Air Force defense. And trying to dive back to the original line of scrimmage is McCarg. Christian Spears coming up from the secondary.
And we'll see now who Air Force will have at defensive end this time. We already talked about, you know, we saw Means at defensive end last time get to the quarterback, get a sack on McCarg. You know, they've moved guys around. They come in and they expect to move around a lot. That's what they do defensively. They send blitzes. Now we have a third and long, so you expect to see another blitz coming at Rice's offense.
They are already without one of their starters, Joseph Champion, hurt his ACL in their regular season finale. McCarg, this time the O-line giving him some time. Now McCarg directing traffic, and he will run for the first down inside the Air Force 40. Well read by McCarg, and a 20-yard gain on the third and 10.
Again, the Air Force moves around, trying to give some confusion to the Rice offensive line. But when you have a quarterback like McCarg, they wanted to corral him. Coach Warren said, we just need to keep him in the pocket, corral him, get some hits on him. This is what he does. If you give him a lane, he will hurt you with a big play with his feet.
Turner Peterson, the junior from Oklahoma City, in the backfield. McCarg looking to go deep down the sideline. Incomplete, and the penalty flag down. The intended receiver was Jordan Taylor, and he was being denied access by Chris Miller.
And Taylor's 6'5", Chris Miller's 5'8", you know, and so you're going to take that matchup problem, just throw it up.
Pass interference on the defense, number three. It's a 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
You'd expect to see offense coordinator John Reagan just take some shots downfield at a 5'8 corner. When you have a 6'5 receiver, put it up in the air, give him a chance. Defensive backs, when they get in that situation, they get nervous when the air is in the ball, when the ball is in the air, and they know that they have a mismatch and they end up having pass interference just because they're afraid that they're going to get an out jump for the ball.
McCarg with the carry down to the 15-yard line. So after the long layoff for Air Force, uncharacteristic with a couple of penalties already here in the first quarter. And look at that, they only average 3 per game. The best in the country.
And 2 pretty big penalties, too. It's a 4th and short with short field with a chance to get into the red zone, which backed them up and made them punt early in this game. So the penalties that they've had have hurt them pretty bad so far. And we'll see if Rice can get points on the board and make this penalty hurt even worse.
Looking to the corner of the end zone, touchdown to Jordan Taylor. His first touchdown catch of the season. Joey, they pick on Chris Miller, the shorter DB again, and they cash in on the turnover that got them the ball back near midfield.
And there's the mismatch. You knew they'd come back to it. Miller just got the pass interference on the other side. Let's go to the other. Let's try him on the other side. 6'5 again.
Play.
Throw it up. Let him make
it's
a play.
Under further review.
They will take a look again at the catch by Jordan Taylor, the sophomore out of Denison, Texas. Did he have possession and a foot down?
Yeah, I don't think that's close. He almost possessed that ball all the way out of the stadium.
Yeah. He's got 2 feet down before Miller tried to knock it loose, and I don't even think he was able to jar it out of there.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. It's a touchdown.
Good job done by Matt Leffler and his crew. And quick work of that replay. Chris Boswell, the junior out of Keller, Texas, on for the extra point. And no surprise, he's got it. He's enjoying a spectacular year. Well, the turnover forced by the Rice defense sets them up nicely. And then Taylor McCarr to Jordan Taylor for six.
When we brought the victory challenge to the streets, we were not going to do it at some freaking poser parade. No, sir, this is Sturgis. Let's ride.
Are you two going to stand here oiling each other's leathers, or are you going to go for a victory ride?
Let's go for a ride. I'm leaving my Harley Davidson at home. I'm taking the victory all the way back to California.
Ride one, and you'll own one. You got that, sweet lips?
Rich, chewy caramel, rolled up in smooth milk chocolate.
Don't forget about that payroll meeting.
Rolo, get your smooth on, also in minis.
What does an Army cop do?
What you do, with one minor difference. Every suspect was a trained killer.
Rolling Stone calls Jack Reacher a dazzling ride.
What is that on your head?
You don't want to know.
Jack Reacher, rated PG-13.
Well, it's that time of year again. Time to get a holiday deal on a Ram truck. A truck that will pretty much haul anything. With a legendary Hemi engine and proven durability that goes the distance. And while most families bring their tree to the house, Ram families bring their house to the tree. Get a great deal at the Ram Big Finish event.
Get $79.50 in total values or 0% APR for 60 months on the 2012 Ram 1500 Bighorn Crew Cab.
Everywhere you go, it seems like someone's offering another deal.
But a really good deal isn't just about what you pay. It's about what you get.
At Wendy's, we stand for quality in everything we make. Like our new Right Price, Right Size menu, featuring fresh ingredients and delicious choices no matter what your budget is. Dad believed in a great meal at a fair price, and it's what we still believe.
At Wendy's, we want you to like what you spend and love what you eat. That's Wendy's way.
Flyover here at the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl. That was pregame here at Amon G. Carter Stadium in Fort Worth, Texas. And off the turnover, Rice cashes in and a 7-0 lead over the Air Force Academy. 4:05 to go here in the first quarter.
Do you think the Air Force guys care about the flyover? Do you think it means anything to them?
I would think it would mean quite a bit. That could be them one day. That might have been a former player up there.
That's
actually
one of my favorite
over.
Parts of playing football was the flyover.
Yeah.
It gave me chills every single time. I just wonder if those guys, I've seen
been
that.
Been there,
before.
Done that,
yeah,
seen that? I would think maybe they would enjoy that. Kick off and bringing it out of the end zone. The Air Force Academy in the all black jerseys. Out across the 25 to the 27 for Anthony Lacoste. Let's check in now the studio. Here's Reese Davis.
All right, Beth, want to give you a peek at what's going on in the other networks on ESPN2. Number one, Duke taking on Santa Clara. Santa Clara is 11-2 in the early part of the season. Duke with a one-point lead. On ESPNU, 23rd-ranked North Carolina State's up on Western Michigan. A really good time to have that Watch ESPN app on your iPad or other device.
This is the perfect weekend for the Watch ESPN app with all that's going on. This is the first of five football games coming your way today on the networks. And the first down run for Cody Getz, the senior out of Buford, Georgia. His season best this year, 222 yards on 25 carries against Colorado.
And Jared Williams has got to stay wide. He can't give up the edge and allow them to get wide and gain those kind of yards in the run game.
The end around, the time of Kirkley. Right across the 45, picking up 8. Let's take a look at our keys to the game, brought to you by Bell Helicopter.
Of course, you talk Air Force. The run game is going to be key here today, not only for Air Force, but Rice also, because their run game sets up the rest of their offense. The QB decision-making, both guys have to take care of the ball. Connor Dietz more so deciding who gets the ball. And then, of course, the turnovers. We already had one early in this game, which led to a Rice touchdown.
That will move the chains. The carry by Wes Cobb. 10 plays, all of them runs here in this first quarter. Over the course of three games late in the year, they ran the ball 91 times in a row. San Diego State, Hawaii, and Fresno. In fact, that Hawaii game, they did not throw the football at all.
And they're able to do that when they gain positive yards on first and second down because it sets up the rest of their offense.
And for a team that averages three penalties per game.
False start. Offense, number 8. 5-yard penalty. First down.
That is the third penalty of the quarter already. And you see the frustration right there from Coach Calhoun.
5-yard penalty to a running offense like Air Force that would rather not throw a pass at all. It is so much harder than normal offense because they don't have an offense where you go and say, okay, now we're going into our pass phase of our offense. They stick with the run.
Three men out of the backfield. The option left, and Dietz will keep it to the 49. Wrapped up by Kyle Prater, a gain of 3.
Nice job by Prater. And that's what we talked about earlier, assignment football. You tackle the guy that you are supposed to tackle no matter what. Open field, they had a guy for running back, and then Prater comes up and tackles the quarterback.
On second down, they'll send MacArthur in motion and back to throw, and immediately taken down is the quarterback, Connor Dietz, Christian Covington. And a very good front four, Joey, that is outstanding as pass rushers. They may not have too many chances to do that today.
You know, Coach Thurman, defensive coordinator, told us, keep your eye in the middle of the defense. Covington here, their main job today is to tackle the fullback. And you can see Covington, 4 sacks on the season, has the ability to get after the quarterback.
It's probably the best interior combo, Covington and Hossein Shaheen, that they've ever had here at Rice. And another negative yardage play for this Air Force offense. Again, the penalty ending up hurting them with the false start. And the punting unit will come back on. Christian Covington with another nice play from that defensive front.
And you can see the way things fall apart for this Air Force offense when they get into longer situations and it's not a run play. It's just not their offense to go into these third and 20. They don't have a play in their playbook, especially a pass play, that's going to pick up anything near 20 yards.
Covington's a member of that Canadian connection for Rice. His dad, an outstanding player in the CFL in his younger days. And the punt will trickle out of bounds at the 22-yard line, a 37-yard boot. And the Rice offense will head back out there under the direction of Taylor McCarg. Now the Rose Bowl is on ESPN New Year's Day. And that will, of course, feature senior running back Monte Ball leading the Wisconsin Badgers against the Stanford Cardinal. And the granddaddy of them all, the Rose Bowl game presented by Vizio. It's Wisconsin and Stanford. Coverage begins at 4:30 New Year's Day on ESPN. And that's also available on the Watch ESPN app. Like the Cardinal or the Badgers in that one, Joey?
I think I like the Big Ten. I'm going with the Badgers in that game.
Close to your roots as a former Ohio State Buckeye.
Barry Alvarez makes a comeback. You know, Wisconsin's lost 2 Rose Bowls in a row. I think that...
And Barry's won 3 of them, hasn't he?
Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. And Barry's coaching the last time they won one. So I really think that Wisconsin will come out and play well in this game.
Stephon Taylor will try and have something to say about that. Over 4,000 career rushing yards, and the Big Ten hasn't been very good in recent years at the Rose Bowl. Of course, the athletic director taken back over on the sideline as Brett Bielema has departed for Arkansas amongst the myriad of coaching changes going on around the country. And that is Luke Turner taking the direct snap for Rice. The halfback in the short yardage situation picks up 3. And he needed one more. First quarter is complete. Dana Bowman, a sergeant first class in the U.S. military, amongst the paratroopers. He came in and delivered the American flag, a double amputee, prior to kickoff. He'll be with Lewis Johnson down on the sideline when we come back.
Duty, integrity, the values that guard our freedoms at home and abroad, the same values that drive the men and women of Armed Forces Insurance to protect those who protect our nation. Visit AFI.org for a no obligation quote. Armed Forces Insurance. Our mission is you.
I'm a mama's boy. Bonus brings my family together. I usually talk longer with my mother. My bill is always flat, it's always the same. No extra cost, no limits on the time, so it just works very good. Everybody has a favorite in their family, and I'm pretty sure I'm the one for my mom, so. Mi nombre es Raul Santoyo, and my mom is why I switched to Bonus.
Get unlimited calling to Mexico and over 60 countries for one low price from any phone.
Should old acquaintance be forgot and never brought to mind? Should old acquaintance be forgot and
Texas Chainsaw, rated R, starts Friday.
Hey!
Hey.
You really like the sweater?
I love it.
Hi, I'm Victor Cruz. As an athlete who's done commercials, I know a thing or two about bad acting. And that was some bad acting. Why don't we return this for some approved gear from Foot Locker?
Awesome.
I felt that. Did you feel that?
I may have retired from the game, but not from being big. Good thing one car gives me full-size luxury and 36 miles per gallon, which is nice because I've got shoes that are bigger than most hybrids. And more stylish, too. If you don't know the luxurious yet fuel-efficient LaCrosse, you don't know Buick.
Don't wait for the new year to experience Buick. Lease this EPA-estimated 36-highway MPG LaCrosse with 2 years of scheduled maintenance for around $299 per month.
Mine was earned off Vietnam in 1968.
Over the South Pacific in 1943.
I got mine in Iraq, 2003.
USAA Auto Insurance is often handed down from generation to generation because it offers a superior level of protection and because USAA's commitment to serve the military, veterans, and their families is without equal. Begin your legacy. Get an auto insurance quote. USAA. We know what it means to serve.
Now here's one of the special things about the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl and the special people you meet. Here's Lewis Johnson.
All right, thanks so much. Here with Sergeant First Class Dana Bowman, who brought that ball in. What a miraculous entry that was. And you're showing a little leg right there. You've got the stars and stripes. Yeah. That, you told me, was nearly your 4,000th jump, but 1,000 after you had the accident that caused you to lose both your legs. How were you able to get back up there and do that?
Well, it was the United States military, the Army, Navy, Air Force, Marines, the Coast Guard. We had opportunity to be able to change and show them that we could still land on target. You know, we have over 50 wounded warriors that have lost arms and legs and are still in active duty. Today, we have over 300 families here. I mean, the families from the wounded warriors are here, and all the participants. We want to thank Bell Helicopter, Mr. Garrison, Brant Ringler. It's just been awesome to be able to jump into this event. This is my 8th jump into the Armed Forces Bowl in 10 years. And so 10 years ago, I had opportunity to be able to do a jump, a night jump. It was just awesome.
I think the one nugget that everybody would love to understand is that after an accident like you had, first of all, you have to have a lot of nerve to jump out. But then after that accident, how were you able to get back up there? And what is the rush like coming down into the stadium?
You know, it was a grueling rehab through Walter Reed Army Medical Center and Bethesda Naval. But, you know, with those physical therapists, the doctors, the RNs, they put it all together. And they showed me that we can still continue on. It was tough, especially re-enlisted back in the Army, being the first double amputee to come back in the United States military.
And actually, we've got a turnover here on the field, so I'm going to say we've had a turnover here, so we'll get that adjudicated in just a moment. But I want to finally say to you, thank you for your sacrifice and your service, and we're glad that all of you are being honored here today. You've given an incredible example, and you've got a coin there, is that for me?
I have a coin that we jumped in here.
All right.
Awesome feat. Go Air Force. You know, I got an opportunity to jump with the Wings of Blue and the Silver Wings from Fort Benning, Georgia.
Fantastic.
But this is special.
And thank you.
you.
We really appreciate what you guys do, but thank you, ESPN.
Thank you very much, Sergeant. All right, incredible, incredible. Back up to you, Beth.
Sergeant First Class Dana Bowman, one of the paratroopers bringing in the American flag today, and a turnover called on the field. And Rice wants to make sure that the officials take another look at this.
The previous play is under further review.
Chris Miller is the guy that forced the fumble, ripped the ball loose from McCarg, but we're going to check it out on replay, and we'll be back right after this.
Green left close, Z-fly tight, fake slash 37, buster solid, naked right, X-sting, Y-spear, on one. Ready?
Ready.
Hi, I'm Drew Brees, and the Brees Dream Foundation is proud to support military families and the Armed Services YMCA. Join us in making military life easier in your community. Volunteer today.
Thank you for making military life easier. Please visit asymca.org.
Buy one, get three is back at Joseph A. Bank. Buy any suit, sport coat, or outerwear. Get three more absolutely free, including signature suits, sport coats, and leather jackets. That's four for the price of one. Expand your wardrobe or split the deal with friends and family. Mix and match any suit, sport coat, or outerwear. Buy one, get three free now. Most stores open at 9 a.m. through Saturday at Joseph A. Bank.
Northern Illinois is looking for the ultimate upset as they take on the ACC champion Seminoles. The 2013 Discover Orange Bowl. Northern Illinois, Florida State, New Year's Day at 8:30 Eastern on ESPN.
Their lives, saving the gators they love.
Every gator I catch is a gator that doesn't die.
Gator Boys, Sundays at 9 starting January 6th. Channel 282, Animal Planet, surprisingly human.
Our score, Rice with the lead over Air Force. The ruling on the field, Rice coughing up the fumble, but it certainly appears, Joey, that the call will be reversed here on review.
Yeah, I think it's pretty easy call. And I think
after review, the player was down. Therefore, it'll be second and seven at the 37-yard line. Rice football.
Yeah, and I think that's a fairly easy call, but more importantly, you know, Rice is on the plus side of the 50-yard line. And if Air Force wants to have a chance to stay in this game, they're going to have to do something to change the momentum here. You know, Rice, if they get up two scores and then you put, you know, this your Air Force offense, and you'd like to run the ball, you can't get down by large margins because it's tougher for you to come back and put up big points that way.
Rice forced a fumble in the first quarter, and then they scored off of that. Taylor McCarg to Jordan Taylor. And a touchdown pass. Most of the yardage has been gained on the ground thus far for both sides. No surprise with two of the better running teams in the country. Second down for McCarg. The delayed handoff to Ross. Diving out to the 44. Close to another first down. Behind that line of Hody, Carlson, Richards, Roya, and Williams. One of the big question marks for this Rice team coming into the season, Joey, after they had five seniors that left. And this new unit has come together nicely by the end of the year.
They have, and they're playing one. You could see it there. Nice blocking. This Air Force defensive line isn't very big, so if you get your hands on them, you can get pretty good push. You could see the offensive line open up a huge hole off the right side.
Big turnaround after a 1-5 start. Rice winning 5 of its last 6 games to get the bowl bid. McCarg will keep, and the ball pops loose as he tried to reach for the first down, and Air Force has it this time. And what looks like it'll be the first turnover for the Academy.
First down.
I think that was Alex Means who was able to punch it out.
I think there's no question that this ball was out. Another big play by Alex Means. Has a quarterback sack today, has a number of tackles, and now forces a fumble.
And a timeout here for Rice.
Rice. First timeout of the half. That's a 30-second timeout. Correction, full timeout.
And now they're going to make that a full timeout, so we will go as well. 7-0 Rice, but Air Force in good shape.
Capital One Cash Rewards Card gives you 1% cash back on all purchases, plus a 50% annual bonus, and everyone likes 50% more.
Jenner! Yeah!
50% more.
You know what I mean?
50% more flash.
50% more taters. That's where tots come from.
The Capital One Cash Rewards Card gives you 1% cash back on every purchase, plus a 50% annual bonus on the cash you earn. It's the card for people who like more cash.
50% more spy stuff. What's in your wallet?
This car's too small.
Hey, look.
Shooting star. Make a wish.
I wish we could lie here forever.
I wish this test drive was over so we could head back to the dealership.
It's practically yours.
Test drive.
But we still need your signature. Volkswagen Sign and Drive is back, and it's never been easier to get a Jetta. That's the power of German engineering. Get zero down, zero due at signing, zero deposit, and zero first month payment on any new Volkswagen. Visit VWDealer.com today.
All right, now that you're part of Junior Motorsports, let's see what you can do.
You know, on second thought, I know something you might be perfect at.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
File your federal return for only $9.95 with TaxSlayer.com.
Visit WatchESPN.com or download the Watch ESPN app to watch ESPN live anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by Vizio.
Welcome back to Fort Worth and the Fort Worth Water Gardens on a sunny but chilly day here in Texas, and Rice leading Air Force 7-0, but off of the turnover, it's 1st and 10 Air Force in Rice territory. They'll try the dive to the fullback Wes Cobb, not much doing there, running into Shaheen and Covington and trying to keep the Rice defense honest.
And Shaheen and Covington have done a pretty good job so far here today tackling the fullback. That's their job in versus this option. That's their assignment. They've done very well to here today. And it sets up another 2nd and long, which Air Force keeps getting in these situations, and it's a tough one to get out of.
Well, travel option, and Dietz is wrapped up by Julius White with the big hit coming up out of the secondary.
Safety Julius White comes down into the box because he knows it's going to be option. His assignment, go get the quarterback. He did it there. Big hit.
Sophomore out of Sugarland, Texas, makes it 3rd down and a dozen. Dietz and the first pass play of the day for Air Force, incomplete. Trying to hit the back, rolling out of the backfield, Cody Getz. And a missed opportunity there for the Falcons off of the turnover.
And Rice brings a corner blitz on a third long, because that's not Air Force's offense. They're not going to get in the shotgun and just run pass plays down the field. They run their plays off of play action, and you have to get in these third and shorts to set up your play action.
And they've had the ball now, Joey, twice in Rice territory, and on both occasions went three and out. Basca is back on. And they'll run the fake. And they will not get the first down yardage. Basca wrapped up at the 42. He needed to get inside the 35. And well played by Kutchler and the Rice special teams.
Difficult place on the field to run a fake punt. Because you have the short field, defensively, the receiving team isn't going to be setting up very many returns because they're expecting to fair catch the ball anyhow. So they're going to be alert to a fake in this situation. As you can see, the defense was ready.
Well done by Kutzler. So now Rice from outside its own 40, first and 10. McCarty. The crossing route and the completion for the short gain to Turner Peterson. Out across the 45. James Chambers, the linebacker, had the coverage. Taylor, who caught the touchdown pass for Rice, now checks into the game. He goes to the near side, the lower part of your screen. And once again, he will have the big size advantage on the shorter Chris Miller, the DB. McCarg looking his way, trying to get Taylor to run deeper, and now McCarg will step out of bounds. And a three-yard pickup will set up a third and two.
I think McCarg was hoping he would have the mismatch you spoke of to the right side, with Taylor being 6'5 and Miller being 5'8. But Air Force on this play dropped their safety back to back up Miller this time, so that they didn't leave him in that mismatch situation. So it essentially had maybe a double team outside on Taylor.
Rice today 3 of 6 on third down. Now that is McCarg staying over near the sideline, and Charles Ross this time setting himself up for the direct snap. He's got it. He's got a couple blockers in front. He picks up the first down and the extra burst inside the 40-yard line and a 10-yard pickup.
Charles Ross is 6'1", 235 pounds. He's a downhill runner. He gets these tough yards. They talked about his strength and his power. You could see it here running through tackles, picking up a big first down.
Again, McCarg will stay to the side, and it's Dreyfus Jackson, the backup QB, the redshirt freshman out of Cedar Hill, Texas, who will stay in the game. And the fake end around, and Dreyfus will keep it and run into Christian Spears, a 5-yard pickup.
This sets up a 2nd and 5 for Rice, and offensively, this allows them to do some of their option read plays and allows McCarg to get out on the edges, where he's pretty good with his feet and throwing the ball downfield.
McCarg comes back in at quarterback on 2nd and 5. Checking over to the sideline. They'll readjust. And the short gainer to Turner Peterson. Again, it's Austin Nicholas on the bottom of that stack. Number 42 for the Air Force Falcons.
The coach talked about how consistent Nicholas has been this season. He's the quarterback of the defense, gets everyone lined up, and then he leads this team in tackles. You can see right there why.
Another third down here for the Rice Owls. Looking left and throwing that way, incomplete. Sam McGuffey didn't have a chance. And it's fourth and five.
Another blitz by the Air Force defense, getting at McHarg, not giving him a chance to stand in the pocket, and also not allowing him to have a seam to break out and run.
So both teams are having good field position and unable to make much of it, but they will attempt a 52-yard field goal here for Chris Boswell. He's got six on the season of 50 yards or better. And the whistle before the kick.
Charge timeout, Air Force.
Boy, Boswell had both the distance and the accuracy on that one, but
plenty
Air Force got the timeout.
Plenty of leg on that one. Sheesh.
David Bailiff chuckling. That little warm-up there for Chris Boswell. One of the most accurate long-distance kickers in the country. The Capital One Bowl League continuing today. We've got games across ESPN and ESPN2 for you, including the Midshipmen taking on Arizona State at 4 o'clock Eastern on ESPN2. And Texas, Oregon State at 6:45. And TCU and Michigan State closing out the night at 10:15 Eastern in the Buffalo Wild Wings Bowl. Capital One Bowl League today on ESPN, ESPN2, as well as the Watch ESPN app. Next bowl up will be the New Era Pinstripe Bowl. And a couple of old Big East rivals in Yankee Stadium, West Virginia and Syracuse. So Boswell will attempt another one. The most long-range kicks on the year. Had three of them in the SMU game alone, and this time he is wide right. So the timeout, an effective one for Air Force. 9 minutes to go here in the first half. Rice with the 7-0 lead off of the missed field goal attempt for the Owls.
Red Lobster is surprising real people with our new 15 under 15 menu.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my gosh, this looks amazing.
15 entrees under $15. It's our new mainstays, like chicken with wine sauce or bacon wrapped shrimp. Try 15 under 15 and see food differently.
It's $9,000 firm.
Really? Show me the Carfax.
Looks like it's had an accident.
Thousand off. What do you guys got? Some kind of crystal ball?
Nope. She's got a Carfax. Just say, show me the Carfax. Get yours now at Carfax.com.
Gator I catch is a gator that doesn't die.
Gator Boys, Sundays at 9 starting January 6th, Channel 282, Animal Planet, surprisingly human.
ESPN College Football, the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl, is brought to you by the Venture Card from Capital One. Earn double miles you can actually use. Volkswagen and
TaxSlayer.com. File your federal return for only $9.95 with TaxSlayer.com.
Well, the fans were out last night for the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl pep rally out at Sundance Square. And the early kickoff here in Fort Worth, and an Air Force offense that averages 436 yards per game has mustered just 56 total yards thus far. As Cal Peterson is on at quarterback. And the pitch to Ty MacArthur trying to get around the edge and a 5-yard pickup.
Just keep getting positive gains. They got to shorten the field. They've got to stay positive and set up the second and shorts, third and shorts. And that's when they can get into their bigger plays. And that's the only way they're going to be able to go downfield with their pass game.
Peterson will keep and stop right around the first down marker. How about Cale Peterson in his one play in the Wyoming game? And it was a doozy as they beat the Cowboys by a point. The rally in the fourth quarter, and Peterson scoring the touch in a 28-27 win. Cale has been in 9 games this year, the sophomore out of Tulsa, who will be the heir apparent trying to take over next year. The coaches did tell us, Joey, that he does have a little bit better arm than Dietz, so we'll see if they try and go to the air a little bit on this drive. Cobb there with the carry.
If they continue getting the negative plays, they're going to need a better arm. You know, that's just not their offense, but that's the situation they've been in here today because Rice has done a nice job of stopping them on first and second down.
Trying to get lined up here, going no huddle. Not much room there for the fullback, just shy of the marker. Let's check in with Reese Davis.
All right, Beth, the number one team in college basketball playing on ESPN2 right now, and Duke is trailing Santa Clara at Cameron Indoor. It's still in the first half, 32-31, but the Broncos are 11-2, so we'll keep an eye on that for you. On ESPNU, North Carolina State's up on Western Michigan.
Thank you, Reese. We're back here in Fort Worth. The first down pickup for Wes Cobb. As they keep things on the ground so far in this first half, just the one pass attempt at incompletion. Everything else has been on the ground, 21 of their 22 plays. And the pass complete inside the 30-yard line to Drew Coleman.
That's the Air Force offense now. They get some rhythm going, run the ball with some success a few times, pick up a couple first downs, and then throw a pass in a running situation.
Cale Peterson standing at quarterback. Fakes the pitch under some pressure and on the run. Taken down after Hossam Shaheen was able to flush him out of there.
And this has been the killer for this Air Force offense all day long. The negative plays. This is putting them in the situation that they have not been able to dig themselves out of just yet.
3-yard loss will set them up second and long.
Second charge timeout for Air Force.
7:02 to go in the half. Air Force on the move. They'll take the TO down a touchdown.
I did in the last 5 hours?
I played a round of golf.
And then I read a book while teaching myself how to play guitar.
Ran 10 miles while knitting myself a sweater. Jumped out of a plane.
Finally, I became a ping pong master
while recording.
My debut album.
How, you ask? With 5-hour energy. I get hours of energy now, no crash later. Wait to see the next 5 hours.
night.
Good night.
You too.
I'm going to dream about that steak.
I'm going to dream about that tiramisu.
What a night, huh? But can the test drive be over now? Head back to the dealership.
Oh, yeah.
It's practically yours.
Sorry.
But we still need your signature. Volkswagen Sign Then Drive is back, and it's never been easier to get a Passat. That's the power of German engineering. Get zero down, zero due at signing, zero deposit, and zero first month's payment on any new Volkswagen. Visit VWDealer.com today.
West Virginia, the next bowl up. Navy also in action later today. Second down and long for Air Force. With a blocker in front, the pitch, MacArthur inside the 15. To the 12-yard line and a 20-yard gain for Air Force.
That's a really nice seal block, cutting off the defensive end. And they just wash everyone down. They get a pulling offensive lineman out front, and that's a nice run and a big play for Air Force.
Four first downs now on this drive. They had just three in the game prior to that. It's Cobb taking it inside the 10. Air Force has used eight different guys to carry the football and have thrown it just twice today. And this, by far, their best look of the afternoon.
And they just look different on this drive. It started off getting some positive yards in their run game, hit a couple passes. They look like they finally got a little bit of rhythm. We'll see if they can finish it off.
Dale Pearson making a big difference on a quarterback. Here he is, got a keeper, trying to get to the corner. And he does. Touchdown, Air Force. On the 10th play of the drive after they make the switch at quarterback, and Pearson brings it home. He looked like Joey. He actually pointed at Anthony Lacoste, number 37. Hey, get me a block there. He said, all right, I'm just going to go myself.
And Lacoste is saying, pitch me the ball. I'm on this side, so you can pitch me the ball.
Extra point is good from Parker Harrington. Now that will tie it up at 7. 47 games in a row now with a rushing touchdown for the Falcons. Now their most impressive drive of the day, they tie it up.
At the forefront of education stands a small school with a big story. One of pioneers, leaders, and entrepreneurs, of Oscars, Pulitzers, and Nobel Prizes. A story of the world's most brilliant minds working together to challenge convention, making discoveries that will change the course of history, and innovations that will change everything. Rice University, advancing the world with unconventional wisdom.
Back here at the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl, Amon G. Carter Stadium in Fort Worth, Texas, even at 7 apiece, 6:14 to go in the first half. As Cale Pearson, the sophomore quarterback out of Tulsa, directs the Academy on a 66-yard touchdown drive after gaining just 56 yards in the first four drives. And that's Jason Kahn's, number 75, in at fullback, leading the way.
Gets downfield, gets a nice block, and you can do that with the Air Force offensive linemen. They're not huge guys. You know, they're about 260. Some of these guys are tight end size offensive linemen. You can put them in your backfield and they run like tight ends.
Does not appear that Connor Dietz was injured, just a coach's decision, as the kickoff is muffed. And Rice able to get it back.
Just coming up and looks like he's looking up into the sun as he's trying to catch the ball, and this gets right between his arms. And fortunately for Rice, gets the ball back.
That was Jeremy Eddington who had a hard time corralling the loose ball. And a very bright and sunny day here in Fort Worth. Now Taylor McCarg and the Owls back to work. Ross may have gotten one. Stephan Attris, the senior out of Fairburn, Georgia, able to wrap him up. And we talked about the Falcons trying to regain a little momentum. Inconsistency has been an issue for this young Air Force team. And really the head-shaking loss to Army when they turned the ball over five times during the regular season. And then the heartbreaking loss to Navy when they had a fourth quarter lead slip away and ended up losing in OT. And Sam McGuffey takes the carry. The senior from Cypress, Texas, close to 1,000 yards rushing and receiving now in his career at Rice.
We've not seen McGuffey go downfield yet. He's their fastest guy. You'd expect at some point in time to see him go deep and show his speed.
Third down, Rice goes no huddle. McCarg gonna keep it, he'll get the first down. And the ball came loose as he took a hit late. You can hear the official saying he was down. But I think Troy Calhoun and Air Force want them to take a closer look. And McCarg is injured after the hit from Stephan Attris.
Yeah, takes a shot to the head, and ball definitely comes out before he hits the ground.
Stephon Batts, and it appears, is the guy that will recover the loose ball. And that was a major collision. No, actually, that was Batts who made the hit. Taylor McCarg, they are now helping him to his feet. Well, it's interesting, Joey, on the short yardage plays prior, we saw them actually use a direct snap to a running back instead of having McCarg carry himself. So McCarg helped to the side. Dreyfus Jackson will come on at quarterback. And I think Troy Calhoun is still trying to work on the officials
the
to say, hey, you got to review that
review.
Play. And what certainly appears to have been a fumble recovered by Air Force. Tied at 7, 5:08 to go, and a review coming. Take a look at the replay here, Joey. Big time collision between McCarg and Batts, and what appears to have popped the ball loose before McCarg's knee is down.
I think there's no question that the ball is definitely out. I think replay wise, you're gonna have to try to figure out who recovers the football. I mean, depending upon how they look at it, to me, it appears that Air Force clearly covers this ball and comes out with it.
After further review, the player fumbled the ball. Air Force recovered it. Therefore, it's first and 10 for Air Force at the 35-yard line.
So the call reversed, and the starting quarterback, McCarr, getting some attention on the right sideline in what could prove to be even costlier than a turnover for the Owls.
And I think that's the most important part. The turnover is huge, but losing McCarr in this situation, him being such a focal point of your offense with the eight TDs passing, you know, he's just the focal point here. 11 TDs rushing. 11 TDs passing. They need McCarg in this game.
Pearson stays in at quarterback. They'll go with the option pass. Incomplete. Inside the 5-yard line. They were looking for Drew Coleman, and it was Dante Strickland making the throw. Dante has a passing touchdown this year.
You can tell there's a different feel to this Air Force team right now. Get a big stop on defense after scoring a touchdown. I don't know if it's Pearson. I don't know if it's the play calling, but something is different about this Air Force team right now, and they look like they're in a much better rhythm.
For more on Connor Dietz, here's Lewis Johnson.
Well, Beth, what's most interesting is that I've been watching Connor on the sideline. Remember at the top of the game, we talked about his shoulder injuries. He has taken no medical attention. Maybe they just wanted a change in the energy that Joey's talking about.
It has certainly been apparent, Lewis, on the field for this Air Force offense after the 10-play scoring drive a moment ago. And the spot appears to be about a yard short. Ty MacArthur with the carry, and that will bring up a fourth and one, and nobody goes for it on fourth down more in the country than Air Force does. And they will pick it up. They're good on fourth down for almost 60% on the season. And after they didn't get it earlier in the game because of the penalty, they do pick it up here.
Yeah, and Pearson has definitely changed this game, especially offensively. The play calling seems better. The teams just seem like they're moving faster. They're running their plays quicker.
Gain of three. Mike DeWitt, the senior out of Austin, Texas. McCarg on his feet. Starting to move around a little bit on the right sideline after the big collision. The pitch, and looking for the edge as Cody gets to the five. Cody Bauer saving the touchdown, but they've definitely got the Rice defense on their heels right now.
That's nice blocking by Air Force. This is a play they run a number of times early in the first quarter and got negative gains on that very play. Now that they're in a better rhythm and they're doing more offensively, they're keeping this Rice defense off balance, and everything seems to be working for them.
First and goal for Cobb, and he stood up at the 1 foot yard, the 1 foot line. As Air Force picks up the tempo to try and smash it in. Good job by Nawasu to keep him out. Second and goal. Cobb again up the middle. Reaching for it. And again, stopped just short. James Radcliffe. Cody Bauer down at the bottom of the pile. Third and goal. Cobb again. And this time he's in. Touchdown, Air Force. Both teams have now scored off of a turnover here in this first half. 2:36 to go. And Air Force has this last couple of possessions. As Cale Pearson has injected new energy into the offense since they made the change at quarterback, and now they've got a 14-7 lead. For 157 yards in this first half for Air Force as we take a look at our Hilton Garden Inn drive recap. And it started with the fumble recovery and the big hit by Stephon Batts.
I think offensively they come out and they're running their plays faster now. They're getting at the line of scrimmage, they're moving around, and you can see it happen here. Crunched over the end zone, go up by 7.
They had to convert on a fourth down play to keep the drive alive, and Wes Cobb with the score, his 9th touchdown of the season for the senior out of Houston, Texas. And Cale Pearson showing some glimpses of what the future will hold, possibly over the next couple of seasons at quarterback for the sophomore. Replacing Connor Dietz in what appears at this point, from what we can gather and from what Lewis has reported, to have been just a simple coach's decision to make the move from Connor Dietz after the offense was stagnant. Kickoff is short and an opportunity here for Moore to return as he runs it out across the 30. And is tripped up there. Let's get to the studio now and Reese Davis.
All right, Beth, coming up in just a few minutes, in case you missed a great ending between Minnesota and Texas Tech last night, we'll relive the finish of the Meineke Car Care Bowl. You ought to see what's happening at Yankee Stadium. It's coming a blizzard. If you like your old school football snowy, you're going to get it this afternoon. West Virginia and Syracuse will look ahead to that. And it might be getting a little bit warm at Cameron Indoor. Duke's getting pushed by Santa Clara. We'll see you in a bit.
Thank you, Reese. And the change of quarterback here for Rice, Dreyfus Jackson, the redshirt freshman, replacing Taylor McCard. He was not returning after taking a pretty good hit on the last possession and coughing up the football. Jackson may have gotten a couple. Good pursuit by the Air Force defense. They too have been reinvigorated. 10 games on the season, including one start. He's got 4 touchdown passes without an interception on the year. He's also run for a touchdown this season. As Taylor McCard continues to watch, being evaluated by the athletic trainers over there on the Rice sideline. Jackson looking deep down the sideline. And another collision and another penalty flag and a pass interference issue continuing with the matchup of Jordan Taylor and Chris Miller.
Pass interference on the defense. Number 3, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Now, I think in this situation, Miller realizes that he's at a size disadvantage here, but he's in good position. Just turn around and play the ball. Defensive backs at times, when the ball is in the air, because they don't look to find the ball, they just watch the receiver, they assume that the receiver has a better shot at the ball than they do, and they grab a hold of him.
That's a couple of pass interference penalties. The 4th penalty of the half for the least penalized team in the nation. Jackson tucks it and then keeps it inside the 45. Here's Lewis Johnson with a report on Taylor McCard.
Yeah, Beth, off our sideline, things have been pretty busy here. The initial information is that McCard has a head injury. And just a few moments ago, we saw one of the trainers who is following, I'm sure, very strict protocol when it comes to head injuries. And if there is a concern about a concussion, then they have to go through some specific questioning. So right there on his phone, he is going through that list of questions, asking Taylor about his situation. And we're told right now that his return is questionable as they continue to evaluate him. Beth?
Thank you very much, Lewis. Of course, with the head injuries and concussions being such an important issue these days in college and professional football. That was the hit that McCard took. Trying to pick up third down yardage. That last penalty flag on the last play, a personal foul against Rice, so that'll set them all the way back to their own 41-yard line. Second and 20. Jackson, McCard's replacement, gonna run with it. They'll get back to the original line of scrimmage and pick up a couple more as well across midfield.
I think it's pretty clear to see that Jackson is a pretty good athlete. Appears to run better than McCard. We haven't seen him throw a pass yet, but as far as being an explosive playmaker with his feet, he's done a nice job so far in his short time of being in the game.
Job here for offensive coordinator John Reagan, former assistant, by the way, at Air Force. Now on the Rice side, and Air Force will call a timeout, and that will be their final timeout of the first half with 1:14 to go. Beth Mullins along with Joey Galloway, Lewis Johnson also with us today here in Fort Worth. And Joey, the quarterback change paying obvious dividends here for the Air Force Academy. Probably not as big a deal for a team that runs a lot and doesn't throw a whole lot.
Well, it's been a big deal so far. I mean, Pearson's come in and their offense has run, you know, go down, score two times, defensively get a turnover. So it has meant a lot to the entire team, not just offensively. They just look different all around, offense, defense, and hopefully the special teams.
They scored on their last two possessions. Things weren't going real well offensively with Connor Dietz in there, so the change made to Cale Pearson, the sophomore out of Tulsa, leading them on a couple of scoring drives. Rice trying to answer with their second quarterback. Jackson on third down. Steps up, throws across the middle. He's got the first down, and once again, it's the big guy, Jordan Taylor at 6'5", hauling it in.
This is a nice throw by Jackson. He's talked about his ability to make plays with his feet. Appears to have a very nice arm. Throws a laser out there to the big guy, Taylor. And Taylor's been the main receiver for Rice here today. He's made a number of big plays. Caught the touchdown. Wow, we have another turnover here.
Turner Peterson is pointing over to the sideline saying, hey, I was down.
Ruling on the field is the player was down.
Well, now Rice wants to try and run this play quickly. Air Force could not get some substitutions into the game. They do not have a timeout to use.
The previous play is under further review.
Hand is down, back is down, shoulder making contact just as the ball started to squirt out of there. The hit from Justin Deku.
Yeah, I think the shoulder was down. It's harder to tell from that angle, but the first angle we had, I think the shoulder hit the ground before the ball comes out.
Deku with the hit on Peterson. That front angle appears to be the best one here. Doesn't matter with the hand, you have to have more of the arm down. It is the shoulder that contacts first, and that is what appears to jar the ball out. They would need, of course, indisputable video evidence to change the call, and it certainly did not appear to be that way. Of course, the other issue, you had a little bedlam going on because Rice wanted to get to the line quickly to snap the ball so there wouldn't be a review, and Air Force had four guys running onto the field trying to make a substitution, and they quickly turned around and ran back. The coaches were trying to push them back out there.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands. Second down.
So it'll be second down for Rice at the 15-yard line with 37 seconds and a couple of timeouts. Peterson stays in the backfield next to Jackson. Jackson looking to the end zone again, trying for the big guy, and this time Chris Miller positioned himself well to break it up.
And Miller does a nice job of turning and locating the ball this time. Don't just assume that you can't make a play on the ball. He locates the ball and almost comes up with an interception here. Actually, a nice job by Taylor to punch the ball out. But Miller, again, early in, we've seen a couple pass interference calls. We've seen the big catch by Taylor downfield because of the height disadvantage. Miller's in good position, turn and make a play on the ball like he did here.
Taylor has one touchdown catch as he got behind Chris Miller back in that first quarter. Jackson will keep it. Down to the 11-yard line and wrapped up there. He's got the first down yardage, and Rice will use its second timeout.
Timeout, Rice. That's our second timeout of the half. That's a 30-second timeout.
Troy Calhoun thought there should have been a holding call on the play. Well, we've got a beautiful sunny day here in Fort Worth, but as Reese Davis reported back in that last studio break, snow's coming down in New York City. Syracuse and West Virginia are on deck, and two of the top quarterback prospects heading into the NFL draft with Ryan Nassib and Geno Smith going toe-to-toe.
Could be a lot of points in that game.
Good to be in the press box for that game.
Yeah, West Virginia, the only thing that may stop some of the offense is the snow. West Virginia doesn't play a whole lot of defense at times, so could great quarterback matchup, could be a lot of points on the board in New York.
Boy, it has been a wild season, hasn't it, for West Virginia? Started out 5-0, everybody started whispering about national championships and undefeated seasons, and then
Geno Smith, Heisman Trophy.
Losses. And now facing their old rival, the Syracuse Orange. First and 10 with a timeout and 19 seconds before the half. Jackson under pressure, throws, caught by Moore at the 5, down to the 1-yard line, and out of bounds to stop the clock with 12 seconds to go.
What the athleticism by Jackson. Stands in the pocket, first read isn't there, second read isn't there, and then here comes a pressure from Fitzgerald. He has the athletic ability to stay on his feet and deliver a pass for a big completion, which sets him up to be able to get into the end zone here, run or pass.
That's the injured starter over there on the bench, Taylor McCarg. Took a big hit a couple of possessions ago. And unable to return thus far, Dreyfus Jackson has replaced him. They'll bring out the chains here to get a measurement. See whether it will be first and goal.
With Jackson's athleticism, the option read play here is a good call. 12 seconds left, they have a timeout left. If they get stopped, they can stop the clock and then try to throw a pass. But Jackson has showed really nice athleticism. I would keep the ball in his hands with the opportunity of running it in.
Two of their last three drives have ended with fumbles. So Rice needing a little ball security here inside the 5, first and goal. Moore lines up to the boundary side, number 15 in white. Jackson runs out of the way, pitches, ball is down, Air Force recovers.
the toughest plays to make for a quarterback running the option is to be able to keep his eyes on the defense and pitch the ball to the running back and deliver a nice ball. As you can see here, Jackson throws a low pass to the running back. That's just a tough play, and not many running backs are going to catch that ball.
Chris Miller able to recover the fumble. David Bailiff in disbelief. Three fumbles ending the last four drives for Rice. And none hurting more than that one inside the 5-yard line. And Air Force has the 14-7 lead heading into the locker room. Down to the field now, Lewis Johnson.
Thank you very much. Coach, tell me first of all about your switch at quarterback. Was that because of an injury to Dietz, or what was the deal there?
Well, we planned on both of them playing coming into the game, and you know, I thought Connor did a solid job in the first quarter. Kale did a nice job of giving us some spark there in the second quarter.
Now, speaking of different quarterbacks, Jackson is now in for Rice. So what kind of spark does he provide, and then how will you have to adjust to him for the second half?
He quality quarterback, and so there's some things we are going to have to make some adjustments at halftime. And we're just going to fight like crazy. I mean, you got a bunch of small, scrappy, overachieving Air Force Academy guys, but they're going to go play in the second half.
Coach, thank you.
Yes, sir.
Beth?
Thank you very much, Lewis. The first half ending with Air Force on top, 14-7. A big turnover inside the 5-yard line. Now to Reese, Lou, and Mark back in the studio.
And Beth, ball on the ground a lot in the first half and a big turnover at the end. The Air Force Academy, which stumbled down the stretch, losing three of their last four. Lou, a pretty important game in your judgment for them because of that.
Oh, I think it's a very important game because for the first time since 2005, the Air Force Academy has lost to both Army and Navy in the same year. That's a lot of the years go by. Those are the two big games on their schedule plus the bowl game. So consequently, they want to end on a very positive note. Having coached against the academies, all three of them, I can promise you, they're going to play to the final whistle of the final play of the game.
And their head coach, Troy Calhoun, does a terrific job. Connor Dietz goes out. He brings in Cale Pearson as the backup quarterback, does a terrific job. Not only running the ball, but throwing the ball. They had three different players throw the ball in this game. Only one completion. Guess who it was? Cale Pearson. He got the only completion, and it was for a first down. And we know Air Force doesn't throw the ball that effectively, but he does the job. He gets it done here, gets the first down. Not only that, you know they're going to run the option. Does a fabulous job here of pointing to a defender right here. Hey, you're not going to catch me. Takes it in for the score, gets the touchdown. And Air Force is leading in this game, and they trailed 7-0. Terrific job of executing their offense.
And Rice trying to hang in too. Taylor McCarg, we'll see if he'll be able to come back in the second half. 14-7, the Falcons have the lead at the break. Perhaps we'll have a finish like the one we had last night in the Meineke Car Care Bowl of Texas. Minnesota and Texas Tech did not think that Minnesota would play that well. Chris Thompson taking over on the interim basis. There's Cliff Kingsbury, who'll be the Red Raiders full-time head coach. Jakeem Grant goes in for the score, but I really want you to watch Jason Morrow.
Right, MMA. Let's get out.
Yeah, he got asked to leave, thrown a punch, and Jace was kicked out of there. Touchdown was reviewed. Ball was knocked out before Grant scores. It was overturned. It moved him back 15 yards. Had to try a field goal. 32-yarder was good until the false start. So then the 37-yarder after the penalty blocked. See what happens? You must keep your composure. A lot of personal foul penalties in this game. People kept saying things about somebody's mama. Seth Dagey to Eric Wardlew.
Well, it's a minute and a half to go in the ball game. You play man-free, no middle safety. That happens. You should never allow them inside.
Less than a minute to go. Minnesota is trying to get in field goal position, and Phillip Nelson showing a lot of inexperience. Picked off by DJ Johnson. Johnson would take the return back 41 yards. He returned it into field goal range. And from there, Ryan Buston.
Knuckleball.
That's putting it kindly. Knuckleball's spin better than that. That was an ugly, ugly kick, but it was a beautiful. Just think, in a few years, when Buston's recounting his game-winning field goal, it'll be a perfect end-over-end kick that went up to the top of the upright.
Could have gone 60.
Yeah, exactly. I would have nailed that thing in from 62. Easy. All right, the total board in the conference game, Big 12 now 2-0 after that win. But, Lou, you noticed something about the tote board.
The SEC not even listening because they haven't started playing yet. They play on January 1. They play all the top-ranked teams because the SEC teams are top-ranked also.
And we'll see, for instance, too, on New Year's Eve, big win in the SEC and the ACC, LSU and Clemson. We've got four more games this afternoon, including a game in snowy Yankee Stadium. We'll take you out to the Bronx in a bit.
This halftime report is presented by Land Rover. Above and beyond.
Hey,
look.
Shooting star. Make a wish.
I wish we could fly here forever.
I wish this test drive was over so we could head back to the dealership.
It's practically yours.
Test drive.
But we still need your signature. Volkswagen Sign Then Drive is back, and it's never been easier to get a Jetta. That's the power of German engineering. Get zero down, zero due at signing, zero deposit, and zero first month's payment on any new Volkswagen. Visit VWDealer.com today.
Where can a marketing administrator be a watercraft engineer? Where can a doctor serve his community while also treating patients around the world? Where can a student stay in school while expanding his education beyond the classroom? In the U.S. Army Reserve, you'll find the strength to develop new skills and gain an edge to get ahead. There's strong, and then there's Army strong. Visit goarmy.com/reserve.
Look, if you have COPD like me, you know it can be hard to breathe and how that feels. COPD includes chronic bronchitis and emphysema. Spiriva helps control my COPD symptoms by keeping my airways open for 24 hours. Plus, it reduces COPD flare-ups. Spiriva is the only once-daily inhaled COPD maintenance treatment that does both.
Spiriva, handy-haler tiotropium bromide inhalation powder, does not replace fast-acting inhalers for sudden symptoms. Tell your doctor if you have kidney problems, glaucoma, trouble urinating, or an enlarged prostate. These may worsen with Spiriva. Discuss all medicines you take, even eye drops. Stop taking Spiriva and seek immediate medical help if your breathing suddenly worsens, your throat or tongue swells, you get hives, vision changes or eye pain, or problems passing urine. Other side effects include dry mouth and constipation.
Nothing can reverse COPD. Spiriva helps me breathe better.
Ask your doctor about Spiriva.
He has inside jokes with complete strangers. Cuba imports cigars from him. Mosquitoes refuse to bite him, purely out of respect. He is the most interesting man in the world.
I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer Dos Equis. Stay thirsty, my friends.
The Discover BCS National Championship on ESPN. The BCS lives here.
We're at halftime in Fort Worth, where the skies are clear. A little bit chilly in Fort Worth. Air Force with a 14-7 lead. Coming up, 3:15 Eastern time, we'll take you to the house that Jeter refurbished. The Yankee Stadium, New Era Pinstripe Bowl, where it is snowing. West Virginia and Syracuse, Chris Fowler has a snow shovel.
A blizzard in the Bronx today as two old rivals, West Virginia and Syracuse, collide in the New Era Pinstripe Bowl here in snowy Yankee Stadium. That's a look out toward center field. Chris Fowler and Jesse Palmer, two very high-powered offenses, two good senior quarterbacks dealing with the big flakes flying.
It starts with West Virginia, probably the most prolific quarterback wide receiver tandem we saw all year, starting with Geno Smith, over 4,000 yards passing. At one time was the front runner for the Heisman Trophy. A lot of people think he'll be the first quarterback taken in this year's NFL draft. Throwing to a guy like Tavon Austin, one of the most dynamic players in the country, you'll see him lined up at wide receiver, running back, and on special teams today. And of course, Stedman Bailey, Geno Smith's high school teammate, one of the best deep threats in the entire country, a Biletnikoff finalist with 23 touchdown catches, expected to put a lot of stress on the Syracuse defense.
And only six picks for Geno all year, but he's lost twice in his career to Syracuse. Ryan Nassib, not as well known a name, Jesse, except to NFL scouts.
Probably the best quarterback in the country that nobody knows about. Very intelligent, very physically gifted. I think he's a first round talent looking ahead to this year's NFL draft. He's throwing to a wide receiver in Alec Lemon, also very unknown. Great in the slot, could break Marvin Harrison's single season receiving record in this game. Then of course, Marcus Sales on the outside, a guy who had three receiving touchdowns in this exact bowl game 2 years ago. With this weather here today, the winner could easily be the team that takes best care of the football and offense.
In a venue known for long ball, both defenses give up lots of long balls. Will the snowflakes get in the way of this scoring fest? The new era Pinstripe Bowl, the Mountaineers, and the Syracuse Orangemen coming up.
You know what they call weather like that in Syracuse, don't you?
Normal.
June. What kind of impact do you think? Syracuse plays inside. West Virginia might be more used to it, the cold anyway. What kind of impact do you expect the snow to have on passing attacks like this?
I think a major impact. If you look at both these teams, West Virginia averages 42 points a game. Geno Smith throwing for 40 touchdowns this year and over 4,000 yards. I expected this to be a high-scoring game, but now looking at the snow and the weather, I don't think it's going to be that high-scoring. I think both teams are going to try to run the ball. They'll try to throw it, but they won't have a lot of success.
As a coach, I felt the offense had advantage in a game like this, because the defense has to react on poor footing. When the receiver's running the route, he knows where he's going. The defender doesn't know. And they'll slip down far more than the offensive player. Same thing with the running back. Same thing with the offensive lineman. I always felt a bad field or snowy field gives a tremendous advantage to the offense, hurts the defense.
The advantage to the offensive line, because in the snowstorm, they can't see a hole.
Wear white gloves.
You perfected.
Right? All of the offensive linemen will have on white gloves if they listen to the Mayday.
Typical Mark.
We come back at halftime, number one team in basketball getting pushed at home.
This halftime report is brought to you by Progressive, making it easy to buy car insurance.
So this board gives me rates for Progressive Direct and other car insurance companies?
Yes.
But you're Progressive and they're them?
Yes.
But they're here?
Yes.
Are you...
there?
Yes.
No.
Are you them?
I'm me.
But those rates are for...
them.
So them are here.
Yes.
You want to run through it again? No, I'm good.
You got it?
Yes.
Rates for us and them. Now that's Progressive. Call or click today.
Join us at ProjectLuna.com.
Buy one, get three is back at Joseph A. Bank. Buy any suit, sport coat, or outerwear. Get three more absolutely free, including signature suits, sport coats, and leather jackets. That's four for the price of one. Expand your wardrobe or split the deal with friends and family. Mix and match any suit, sport coat, or outerwear. Buy one, get three free now. Most stores open at 9 a.m. through Saturday at Joseph A. Bank.
Bagista was a gangster. A DM guy.
I'm going after Mickey Cohen.
Well, you gotta die of something.
Can't shoot me. You're a cop.
Not anymore.
Gangster Squad. We did our.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student-athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
More bowl games coming your way. Unlike snowy Yankee Stadium, AT&T Park in San Francisco will be much nicer for Navy and Arizona State.
It's just going to be beautiful. Plus, Arizona State is very good on defense against the pass. They have some problems on the run, and Navy does run the triple option exceptionally well. I think Arizona State, though, is a Pac-12 team that will be looking to redeem the Pac-12.
That's in the Kraft Fight Hunger Bowl, the Valero Alamo Bowl, Oregon State and Texas.
Tale of two quarterbacks, Cody Vass for the Beavers, 11 touchdown passes, one interception. He's got two great wide receivers in Marcus Wheaton and Brandon Cooks. On the other side of the ball, how about David Ash? 17 touchdown passes, can run the ball, very mobile. Question is, he doesn't have that many great wide receivers to throw to. Is it consistent as Oregon State?
That's at 6:45 Eastern on ESPN. And then the nightcap, Buffalo Wild Wings, TCU, and Michigan State.
Oh, I think this ought to be a tremendous game, although Michigan State is very good on defense, had trouble moving the ball on offense. But here you see Boykin, the winning quarterback for TCU. They've had to go through so many of them. But then you have Le'Veon Bell. He is outstanding.
That's at 10:15 Eastern time, the Texas-Oregon State game. earlier on ESPN is being clouded by the suspensions of Jordan Hicks, an injured linebacker, and backup quarterback Case McCoy, both of whom were sent home for violating team rules. Now, this decision came just after San Antonio police told a television station there was an allegation of a sexual assault. No charges have been filed, and neither the players have not been connected with that directly, so I'm not implying that they are. What I am saying is there's a distraction for Texas now, so how do they handle it in this game?
Well, Mac Brown's a seasoned veteran coach. He's played for a national championship and won a national championship at Texas. He knows how to circle the wagons and get his players prepared to play mentally, and I don't think that's going to be an issue. He'll explain to his team what has happened. This is what they have to do. These are our goals. This is what we have to do to win this game. We're going to move on, fellas. We're going to circle the wagons. We're going to play Texas football.
As a football coach, you don't make a decision to send them home. They made that decision. You say life's a matter of choices. Wherever you are, good or bad, a choice you made. You choose to miss curfew, you're choosing to go home. Players say, oh, please, coach, don't do it because you didn't honor your word. Please don't ask me to break mine. You go to the team, this is the way it is. We're a team, it's not individuals. Case closed. Close ranks, pick up the rifle, and march on.
Texas trying to finish on an up note after a little bit of a disappointing finish. Oregon State trying to get its 10th win in the Valero Alamo Bowl tonight. Come back at halftime, I told you the number one team in basketball getting pushed by Santa Clara, but Duke trying to go on one of those patented runs. We'll show you how the Blue Devils are doing when you come back.
I'm a mama's boy. Bonus brings my family together. I usually talk longer with my mother. My bill is always flat, it's always the same. No extra cost, no limits on the time, so it just works very good. Everybody has a favorite in their family, and I'm pretty sure I'm the one for my mom, so. Mi nombre es Raul Santoyo, and my mom is why I switched to Bonus.
Get unlimited calling to Mexico and over 60 countries for one low price from any phone.
These new phones they got us are great.
Yeah, it's the Galaxy Note 2.
You can do two things at the same time. You can watch videos and text.
Or you could watch the earnings report and take notes, like we're supposed to.
So, can I get it?
Yeah. Either of you put together the earnings reports yet?
Yes, me, totally.
What? Why don't you tackle the next quarter? You eat it?
Polynesian?
Poopa platter?
Yep. Keep up the good work.
I will keep up the good work.
Do more with the new Samsung Galaxy Note 2.
Brace yourself for a whole new way to watch Showtime with Showtime Anytime. Woo-hoo! It's all the homeland. Dexter, House of Lies, Shameless, movies, sports and comedy you want, anytime you want, anywhere you want.
This is it. This is the moment.
It's Showtime. Anytime, everywhere. Showtime Anytime. Free with your Showtime subscription. Go to ShowtimeAnytime.com to create your account today.
Coming up on Sunday NFL Countdown, Cowboys, Redskins, win and get in.
It's for all the marbles, whatever you want to say.
We're one-on-one with Washington head coach Mike Shanahan and Tony Romo's soundtracks.
Check. Shake 94. H-Drag. Got one, right?
Plus, Colts head coach Chuck Pagano and his return to the sideline.
It's an inspiration. You're like, I got to get back. You know, I got to get well.
Only on Sunday NFL Countdown, 10 a.m. Eastern on ESPN.
On ESPN2 right now, number one Duke against Santa Clara. Coach K and the Blue Devils had a 9-point lead. Tyler Thornton lobbing for Mason Plumlee. What do you think of the way Mason Plumlee's playing, Lou?
Oh, I think he's playing very well. You know, he's a young man who's improved his free throw shooting by 17% since last year. Candidate for the Heisman for the award, the
Wooden Award.
The Wooden Award, excuse me.
There you saw Kevin Foster knocked out a three, then Plumlee got a rebound. The freshman Rasheed Suleiman's ahead of the pack. Second half, Evan Rockmore rocking the bounce pass. If you can bounce pass well, you can play at any level.
Oh, you can't have. But also, when they overplay you, they're susceptible to the back court.
The back door. And when Seth Curry's on the floor, you're susceptible to the three. He's got 19, Duke's up 8.
This halftime report is brought to you by TaxSlayer.com. File your federal return for only $9.95 with TaxSlayer.com.
Now, don't forget to say TaxSlayer.com. It's quick and easy, and it's free to start. Emphasize the word free. Just put a smile on your face. You'll be great.
TaxSlayer TV commercial. Take one.
Say something, man.
File your taxes for free with TaxSlayer.com.
This is not good. Cut.
Let's give thanks for an idea. A grand idea called America. The idea that if you work hard, if you have a dream, if you work with your neighbors, you can do most anything. This led to other ideas, like liberty and rock and roll, to free markets, free enterprise, and free refills. It put a man on the moon and a phone in your pocket. Our country's gone through a lot over the centuries and a half, but this idea isn't fragile. When times get tough, it rallies us as one. Every day, more people believe in the American idea. And when they do, the dream comes true. We're grateful to be a part of it.
Pizza Hut's $10 any pizza deal is back.
Any pizza, topping, sizes,
$10. The Meat Lover's Pizza.
$10. Delivery, dine in, or carry
out of this world pizza.
Pizza Hut's $10 any pizza deal is back.
Now that's how you make it great.
ProjectLuna.com. You're watching ESPN's presentation of Capital One Bowl Week.
It's about to get right in here, but if you want to fight, get out of here.
Everybody get amped up.
Have a good day.
A couple of amped up running games here at the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl with Rice and Air Force, and a 14-7 lead for the Falcons over the Owls. Bet Mullins along with Joey Galloway and Lewis Johnson with you this afternoon here in Texas. Turnovers a big part of the story in that second quarter for the Rice Owls, and a couple of changes at quarterback, one for each side. It worked out particularly well for Air Force.
Yeah, Pearson came into the game and we didn't know what happened to Deets. We didn't know if he was hurt. They just made a quarterback change and Pearson came in and changed the whole momentum for this Air Force team, drove them down, scored two times. He's looked impressive early in this game.
And then Dreyfus Jackson had to come on in relief of Taylor McCarrick for Rice. And unfortunately, after McCarrick had fumbled twice, Jackson had him knocking on the door, and then he coughed it up as well inside the five on the tough pitch.
And I think Jackson did a pretty nice job besides the errant pitch, but he looked very athletic, threw a very nice strike down the field for a big play. So it's interesting to see both of these backup quarterbacks have played well in the first half. We'll see what they do coming out in this third quarter.
14-7, Air Force, and a couple of touchdown drives from Cale Pearson. They stayed primarily on the ground. In fact, 37 plays, only three of them pass plays in that first half. And Air Force will have the football to start out in the third as we take a look at today's Buick playbook.
Rice decides to go with the option play down on the goal line, 12 seconds left in the first half. And you can see Atrus is the unblocked guy on the end. as Jackson comes around, you can see the ball just slips right out of his hand and then goes and hits the ground for the fumble. But makes the right play to make the pitch, it just slips out of his hand.
Pearson will stay in at quarterback for Air Force. And the give to West Cobb. Joey, did you like the call to keep it in Jackson's hands initially, or would you like to have seen him gone for the 6'5 receiver again in Jordan Taylor?
I like keeping the ball in Jackson's hands. I'm not sure how to run a true option play with a pitch involved. That's too close to the goal line. Too many bad things can happen, as you've seen there, the fumble.
Three-man eye, and Pearson almost coughed it up. Now they're going to rule that an incomplete pass. Running to the short side of the field.
And I think Pearson in this situation made up his mind that he wanted to run, and at the last second decides, let me try to throw a pitch, and then tries to hold on to it and just makes it incomplete pass.
The first four drives under the direction of Connor Dietz, just three first downs and no points for Air Force. And then the last two drives for Pearson, eight first downs and a couple of touchdowns. One scored by Pearson himself this time of the year, and he's got his man wide open at midfield. Dante Strickland, and the big gainer inside the 45, and a 29-yard pickup.
And this is the spark that Pearson has brought this Air Force offense. Early on in the game, they were in these third and long, second and longs, and they couldn't throw a pass because the defense was expecting pass. Now that Pearson has come in and they've had success running the ball, they can also have success with their play action passes and getting the ball downfield.
29 yards, the longest play of the game for either side. Pearson keeps and goes nowhere. Well read that time by Rice, and Hossam Shaheem, first guy there. There you see the total yardage under Dietz and Pearson. Yeah, much more effective with Pearson. And as we've seen, Joey opening things up with his ability to throw the ball a bit better. MacArthur. Short gainer.
That's a nice hustle by Jared Williams, a defensive end for Rice. You know, having the ability to play inside and then make the play to the sideline, getting outside, making sure that the running back couldn't turn the corner. Really nice hustle by Williams.
Now it's third and nine. And once again, usually for Air Force, anywhere on the field in short yardage situations, it's four down territory. Pearson back to pass, deep down the middle, and he will overshoot his target, Drew Coleman. And in this situation, fourth and eight may be a punting situation, and they will send out David Baska.
I think Pearson had more time than he thought. Appeared to rush himself a little bit, get the ball out before he necessarily had to. Had a receiver open. He just could have relaxed and threw the ball across the field and let the receiver run to it.
Yeah, Pearson had only attempted 21 passes all year prior to coming on today. Fair catch and off the hop inside the 15, down to the field, and Lewis Johnson.
All right, Beth, well, we saw in the second half, Rice quarterback Taylor McCarr take the hit to the head, and then he was evaluated here on the sideline for a possible head injury. Well, at the end of the half, as he was coming out of the locker room, head coach said that he was still being evaluated, but I just got the word a second ago that McCarr is out. So apparently he has got an issue with a concussion. So now Dreyfus Jackson is going to be the quarterback for the rest of this game. And in terms of other adjustments that David Bailiff wants to make, number one, he said they put the ball on the ground five times, Rice did, so they want to try and stop the turnovers, and they need to just be more physical, he says, along with defensively make some adjustments to deal with that sweep that Air Force had been running. So those are the issues there, but the biggest deal is the quarterback is gone.
Thank you very much, Lewis. Charles Ross on the carry. Austin Nicholas with the tackle. So Dreyfus Jackson, who came on in relief of McCarg in that second quarter, threw it three times for 33 yards and had the costly fumble on the pitch inside the five at the end of the first half. And Nico Carlson is now the injured player here for Rice, the sophomore left guard. Carlson helped to his feet and will head over to the sideline. I'll take a minute here to remind you that the Discover Orange Bowl is on ESPN New Year's night with Northern Illinois. Out of the MAC, taking on Florida State, champions of the ACC, the Discover Orange Bowl. New Year's Day at 8:30 on ESPN, also on ESPN Radio, and your Watch ESPN app. Know a lot of folks nationwide, Joey, rooting for the little guy in that one. See if Northern Illinois can do some damage. Matt Simonette is now in to replace Carlson at left guard. We'll run the draw to Ross. He spins out across the 25. We'll have the first down, a 7-yard pickup. Brian Lindsay with the tackle. The eighth non-AQ team to play in a BCS bowl is Northern Illinois, and they've done all right, 5-2 for the smaller schools. And for Florida State, they have struggled in BCS play.
And Florida State's a team, you know, a two-loss team. You know, they lost to an unranked NC State team. So if you're Northern Illinois and you had to play one of the big boys, I would take my chance with Florida State because they've been known to lay an egg every now and then.
Hand off on first down to Ross. Alex Means making the tackle. One of the things that Charlton Warren, the defensive coordinator for the Falcons, talked about is we can't get mauled up front with the big size deficiency, but those guys up front have done a nice job of taking out the O linemen so the linebackers can make a lot of plays.
I mean, they really have. Those guys are 240 to 250 on the defensive line. They're undersized. They realize that. They try to counteract that with movement, with bringing blitzes, with slanting, and they've done a pretty nice job here today.
Jackson, good protection. Throwing downfield, almost picked off by Miller. And it did not appear Sam McGuffey was expecting that throw.
That's a dangerous pass. And at times, receivers, you know, when you read a coverage and you know what the play is and you don't think the ball should come to you, you don't expect it. And that's, and I agree with you, it looks like he just didn't expect it because if you look at the coverage, that's the wrong place for the ball to go to. So at times, receivers get in trouble because they read a defense better than a quarterback does at times and don't realize the ball is still going to come.
6 of 11 on third down today is Rice. Checking down, drop it off to his tight end, and a first down and more across midfield to Vance McDonald. Invited to the Senior Bowl at 6'5 out of Winnie, Texas, having a big finish to his career.
Nice job by Jackson. Tried to force one a play ago. This time takes his time, relaxes, stays in the pocket, steps up, finds his big tight end for a big play.
That's the longest play of the day for Rice. Into Air Force territory under the direction of Dreyfus Jackson on replacing the injured starter Taylor McCarg at quarterback. Taking a hit and delivering downfield and complete to Jordan Taylor.
The ability of Jackson to stand in the pocket, realize the pressure is coming, and wait on his big receiver Taylor to run the post route and delivers it low. That way, only Taylor can get to the ball.
Back-to-back pickups of 20 yards or better here for Jackson. And the pass to Taylor with that big size advantage at 6'5". Jackson keeps nice sidestep of the defensive back Christian Spears, and what looked like it was going to be a negative play, he picks up a couple.
Yeah, I think Jackson is clearly a really good athlete, quick on his feet, and surprisingly a pretty strong arm. He has played very well since coming into this game. Interesting, on both sides, the backup quarterbacks have looked like starters since they've come into this game.
Christian Spears will remember that little shake and bake move. Jackson looking for his 6'5 wide receiver, and he's got Jordan Taylor with his second touchdown catch of the day. Going right over the top of 5'8" Chris Miller.
There's a height disadvantage. We talked about this earlier. 6'5", put it up in the air. 5'8" corner can only have a chance to get that ball if you throw it low. He had a chance earlier. That one, really nice throw by Jackson. Back shoulder up in the air.
Chris Boswell's PAT ties it up at 14 apiece early in this third quarter. The backup quarterback, Dreyfus Jackson, dropping it right in to Jordan Taylor. And we are all even in Fort Worth.
The Mercedes-Benz winter event is back with the perfect vehicle that's just right for you, no matter which list you're on. Oh,
ho, ho, ho.
Lease a 2013 C250 for $349 a month at your local Mercedes-Benz dealer.
Cleanup team at 1-800-SERV-PRO. Like it never even happened.
Division I student athletes have higher SAT and ACT scores than college-bound students.
The number of us receiving diplomas
is at an all-time high.
African-American males who are student athletes
are 10% more likely to graduate.
Still think we're just a bunch of dumb jocks?
You need to do your homework.
There are over 400,000 NCAA student athletes, and just about all of us will be going pro in something other than sports.
Tonight, it's a top 25 matchup between the number 23 Longhorns and the 13th ranked Beavers. Capital One Bowl Week continues with the Valero Alamo Bowl. Tonight at 6:45 on ESPN. College football lives here.
Back here at the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl. And at halftime, the Great American Patriot Award handed out to General Norton A. Schwartz, former Chief of Staff of the U.S. Air Force. The Great American Patriot Award winner from Armed Forces Insurance. And a special moment for he and all the veterans that were down on the field. A lot of servicemen and women in attendance here. Of course, no state in the Union provides more military personnel than Texas does. The most members of the armed services, and of course, a tremendous Army, Air Force, and even Navy bases here in the state of Texas. The kickoff to Air Force, Anthony Lacoste will take it in the end zone. Got a Naval Air Station right here in Fort Worth. The Army's famed first Cav down at Fort Hood, and the Laughlin Air Force Base down near Del Rio, the most active pilot training base for the United States Air Force. We are told that on weekdays, Joey, it is the busiest airport in America. with all the training missions going on.
That's why they weren't excited about the flyover, bro. They see so many of them.
Impressive nonetheless, and a big thank you to all the members of our armed forces serving around the country and around the world. Of course, for these Air Force cadets, 5 years of service to the United States after graduation. Quarterback Connor Dietz will start his in a couple of months. Dietz has been replaced at quarterback by Cale Pearson, number two in the black jerseys. It's been a decent day for the backups. Pearson, a coach's decision coming on, and Jackson, due to the injury to McCarg, has come on. Had three passes, Joey, of over 20 yards on that last touchdown drive. As Dietz watches Pearson, he was able to move the offense effectively in that second quarter.
Miss a big third down for Pearson. He's going to have to make a play with his arm here eventually.
Trying to here, but he's under some pressure. Pitch it forward, incomplete. And now it's the Rice defense that is all fired up.
And actually had a guy open on the sideline early in this play. He just didn't have a chance to stead his feet and find him. But if he could have plenty of room on the sideline, softer coverage, receiver was open, plenty of room to get the ball in there. It's just the rush was there to give him a chance.
Cameron Nuwasu, the junior linebacker from Houston, providing the pressure. Punt is a short one. Callahan with the fair catch, and Rice will have it at their own 48-yard line with 8:10 to go and a chance to take the lead here at the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl.
You know, printing from a smartphone instantly makes you look a whole lot smarter.
That man
is a machine.
Enjoy everything a business traveler needs to stay successful.
Every smart business person knows it's always a good idea to put in some overtime with your family.
From weekday work to weekend fun, we have everything you need for a successful stay.
That's going to blow you away. Visa.com is the web's most trusted penny auction source, with discounts you have to see to believe. There are hundreds of brand name, brand new products every day, and they're delivered lightning fast right to your door. Laptops, tablets, gift cards, big screen TVs, and way more. All at blowout prices. Visa is happy to offer for new users $100 off their first auction win. These are a few items that have recently been won for under $100. And because the price only moves up one penny at a time, you get incredible discounts like 85, 95, even 99% off retail. To make sure you're warmed up, Visa offers free bids to those who join, so you can try it now risk-free. See the code at the bottom of your screen? Enter it when you join to take advantage of this special offer. Shop smart, save more, have fun at Visa.com. That's BEEZID.com.
ESPN College Football, the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl, is brought to you by ProjectLuna.com, Hilton Garden Inn, and Taco Bell. Sometimes you gotta live mas.
Nothing like a little brisket from Billy Bob's here in Fort Worth. The two teams getting together
for a meal last night. Well, it's been a day for quarterback changes, and Taylor McCarg, who was injured with an apparent head injury in that first half, has now come back out onto the sideline in his street clothes. And what appears Dreyfus Jackson will try and take them the rest of the way. Jackson leading the Owls on a touchdown drive the last time they had the football, and here they go again. And a little end around for Parks. And nice play to hold the edge for the Falcons and Christian Spears.
Spears does a nice job of staying at home, playing center field, and then when he comes up, he brings a wall up. Comes up. Nice play, nice tackle in the open field. It's tough to get those athletes down in the open field, but that's a really nice play by Spears.
Almost looked, Joey, like he had more space if he had gone outside the block there. Now they'll bring in Turner Peterson here for a direct snap, which they've utilized mostly in short yardage situations today. He will hand it off. So that'll bring up a third down here for Dreyfus Jackson. And there is starting quarterback Connor Dietze warming up again for Air Force after Cale Pearson had replaced him.
It looks like he's coming back in. I mean, he's bouncing around. He's blowing on his hand to keep it warm. He looks like he'll be in next series.
Well, an interesting choice there for Troy Calhoun. Pearson looked good in the second quarter. Wasn't able to move them on the first drive of this third quarter. And a flag.
Before the snap, delay game on the offense. 5-yard penalty, third down.
I'm surprised we haven't had more of those types of penalties with both backup quarterbacks being in the game, but both guys have played well and managed the game well, with that being the first penalty of that sort. And that is a penalty that you usually get when guys are confused and not really paying attention to the clock, and you get that for backup guys.
Looks on here. They're 7 of 12 on third downs today. Jackson checking it down for Peterson, lunging for the marker, and appears to be just short. And now a decision for David Bailiff, as his Rice Owls have seized the momentum here in the third quarter.
I think that spot is a little short, first off. I think he had another yard, but I would go for this on fourth down, even with it being a long 2 yards.
Jackson will stay in there. Jackson flushed out. And the pass knocked out of his hands by Brian Lindsay. So the Air Force defense makes the play on fourth down, and they will take over.
Air Force does a really nice job of taking away the first read. They want to go play action and hit a quick pass to the tight end. The linebacker stayed at home, took away the quick pass, and then Jackson tried to make a play with his feet. Really nice rally by the Air Force defense.
Well, we saw the penalties hurting Air Force on a couple of occasions in the first half, Joey, and there the delay of game costing Rice a first down. And it is, in fact, Connor Dietze back in there at quarterback, pitching it to Getz. So Dietze returns and left the game with 12 minutes to go in that second quarter. Ineffective in moving the offense. They'll work a bunch of guys roaming around in the backfield. It ends up in the hands of Ty MacArthur. Gain of 3, and that'll bring up third and about 4. Bryce Callahan with the tackle. Bryce returning from a broken arm, which kept him out for the last couple of months of the season.
That's nice blocking downfield by Chris Jordan, the wide receiver. Has blocked very well all day long, sealing the edge and allowing guys to get around the corner.
Dietze with the pitch and cut down at the 48-yard line. That'll be a couple of yards short. Good pursuit from Paul Porras. And an injured player down on the field for Rice. That starting linebacker, James Radcliffe, the sophomore out of Katy, Texas. He's going to be number 10 in the white jersey. While he gets some medical attention, we will take the timeout, tied at 14.
You know, printing from a smartphone instantly makes you look a whole lot smarter.
That man
is a machine.
Enjoy everything a business traveler needs to stay successful.
Every smart business person knows it's always a good idea to put in some overtime with your family.
From weekday work to weekend fun, we have everything you need for a successful stay.
Mine was earned off Vietnam in 1968.
Over the South Pacific in 1943.
I got mine in Iraq, 2003.
USAA Auto Insurance is often handed down from generation to generation because it offers a superior level of protection and because USAA's commitment to serve the military, veterans, and their families is without equal. Begin your legacy. Get an auto insurance quote. USAA. We know what it means to serve.
DiGiorno or delivery? DiGiorno or delivery? Taste for yourself why the shortest distance between you and a delicious fresh baked pizza is your oven. Thankfully, it's not delivery, it's DiGiorno.
Red Lobster is surprising real people with our new 15 under 15 menu.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my gosh, this looks amazing.
15 entrees under $15. It's our new mainstays, like chicken with wine sauce or bacon wrapped shrimp. Try 15 under 15 and see food differently.
Back here in Fort Worth and via the Bulls corporate partner program, TaxSlayer.com presented several hundred tickets to service members so they can attend today's game with their families free of charge. Here at the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl in Fort Worth, Texas, we are tied at 14. And the team that goes for it on fourth down more than any other in the country appears to be going for it again right here on fourth and a few from just across midfield. Air Force in the all black, Rice in the white and blue. Connor Dietz checking the sideline. Cobb becomes the lone setback. Dante Strickland running back there, trying to figure out what's happening. The play clock, they're not going to get the snap off here. They didn't even get to the line of scrimmage to try and draw Rice off.
Fourth down. Yeah.
Let's check in right now with Reese Davis.
All right, Beth, Santa Clara and Duke game played on ESPN2. At one point, this was a 45-41 game, and then Duke ran away. Mason Plumlee a little flush. Seth Curry had 31 as the number one team in the country finished 90-77. Geno Smith in West Virginia at a snowy Yankee Stadium getting set to go against West Virginia, or against Syracuse, I should say.
Thank you, Reese. And on the punt It hit Sam McGuffey, and he jumped on it, and we've got a penalty flag down as well. Back where Bryce Callahan was set as the return man.
There's no foul for kick catch interference. First down, Rice.
As a return man, you've got to talk to your guys blocking for you because they have no idea where you are. They're more concerned with their own guy. You have got to tell them, get away, get away, get away, so they run out of there and you don't have situations like this.
Rice had all kinds of traffic back there. First and 10 now for Dreyfus Jackson. After Air Force could not get anything going on that fourth down play, and a strange ending to that possession for the Falcons. Jackson went to action, and he will run right into the defender. Another tackle for loss. This time, it's Stephan Attris, the linebacker.
And this was a nice assignment football by Air Force. Safety Christian Spears had the running back. Attris takes the quarterback, gave him nowhere to go and nowhere to pitch the ball.
Loss of 5, second and 15. Jackson with the completion out into the flat. Another nice move in the open field, and out across the 30-yard line is Dante Moore. Was able to shake loose from Alex Means. Well, Rice usually, throughout the course of the season, wasn't very good in the third quarter, but not the case today. Jackson has the first down. His favorite target today has been the 6'5" sophomore Jordan Taylor.
Nice completion by Jackson. You just like to see him do it a little quicker. Realize where your soft coverage is. Realize where your hitch is. Drop back, get the ball out of your hands, and avoid taking any extra hits.
Taylor now with 5 catches, 89 yards. He's got both of their touchdown receptions. He lines up in the slot and now will step back on the receiver screen. Breaking out of the bubble across the 45-yard line. Brian Lindsay able to knock him out. Jackson on that last touchdown drive, 3 pass plays of over 20 yards. He finished it up with the touchdown throw to Jordan Taylor. Tempo. McGuffey's got the first down across midfield. To the 47-yard line. Vance McDonald had a nice block. Spring McGuffey.
You can tell they're successful on these bubble screens and these plays outside because their wide receivers do a nice job of blocking downfield. Dante Moore there driving the corner 10 to 15 yards downfield. That is terrific blocking by a wide receiver.
And Vance McDonald taking out 2 guys on his block. Play action. Jackson, a lot of time, and he's got his man once again, Jordan Taylor. First down, Owls. 6th catch of the day for Taylor, who comes up favoring that right arm a little bit.
Taylor does a really nice job of going downfield and finding a soft spot in the zone. You can see Air Force there is covering air. Taylor goes down 10, 15 yards, sits down, and Jackson delivers a strike.
Taylor will stay in the game, trying to shake it off. He's the lone receiver to the right. Lined up once again with the shorter Chris Miller. Jackson looking the other way. Down deep, McGuffey holds it in at the five. First and goal, Rice. 8 yards on that one, Joey.
It's a nice throw by Jackson. When he sits in the pocket and gets his feet set, he delivers a very nice ball. Throws his ball to the outside of McGuffey's body to allow him to stay away from the safety who's closing in. And then it's a nice catch by McGuffey.
Four passes of over 20 yards now for Jackson, and Sam McGuffey has gone over 1,000 yards receiving and rushing in his Rice career. The first Owl to ever achieve that. Tremendous athlete out of Cypress, Texas, as the third quarter comes to a close here in Fort Worth. Air Force had the momentum going into the locker room. Rice has grabbed it coming out. And hello, how you doing? And many thanks to the members of the U.S. military.
Duty. Honor. Integrity. The values that guard our freedoms at home and abroad. The same values that drive the men and women of Armed Forces Insurance to protect those who protect our nation. Visit AFI.org for a no-obligation quote. Armed Forces Insurance. Our mission is you.
Fun it is to ride. Get the Mercedes-Benz on your wish list at the winter event going on now through December 31st. Lease a 2013 E350 for $579 a month at your local Mercedes-Benz dealer.
Sometimes circles just make sense. That's why the Get Around Knee system from Stryker is designed to replace the knee's naturally circular motion. Other knee systems follow an oval motion. Don't just replace your knee. Replace the way your knee moves. All surgery has risks. Recovery takes time and individual results vary. The lifetime of any device is limited and depends on several factors like weight and activity level. Ask your doctor if the Get Around Knee is right for you.
Save big money during Menards' New Year's sale. Create a new look with special order custom craft countertops. Standard laminate comes in over 200 colors and is stain resistant. Starting at $11.99 a linear foot for modern edge. High resolution comes in over 40 colors and offers the multi-textured look of natural stone. It has three times the industry standard for wear resistance. Starting at $16.99 a linear foot for modern edge.
It's great.
Hoping for something better? Then come celebrate the Hyundai Holiday Sales Event with great vehicles like the powerful Genesis or the luxurious Equus. Each with Hyundai Assurance, including America's best warranty.
This is great.
Now lease a 2013 Genesis for zero down payment, zero first month's payment, and zero security deposit. Visit myhyundaichicago.com.
Visit watchespn.com or download the Watch ESPN app to watch ESPN live anytime, anywhere. Brought to you by Vizio.
Heading to the fourth quarter here in Fort Worth. Happy holidays to you and yours. Sam McGuffey over 1,000 yards in his career, both rushing and receiving. The first Rice Owl to do that. Rice Big turnaround for them in a positive way in the third quarter to tie this score. We've seen four different quarterbacks. We've seen a couple other running backs take direct snaps. And that is today's game track brought to you by TaxSlayer.com. Dreyfus Jackson, one of those four QBs, has Rice on the move, looking for the lead. On in relief of the injured starter, Taylor McCarg, who went out with a head injury in the second quarter. Jackson gonna keep, and he will be held short. And there are a couple of Air Force players a little slow to get to their feet, including the tackler, Ryan Lindsay, number 31.
Really surprised to see Rice go back to the option play, especially at the end of the half. You know, that was the play they fumbled. I would go to the run option, you know, fake it to the running back and either give it or keep it, but to take a chance of pitching the ball again on the goal line.
They will hand it off this time. Right up the middle, Jones, Charles Ross, and the Rice Owls take the lead.
Blocking by the offensive line here, opening up a huge hole. And this is the play you'd expect them to run on the goal line. They do it so well, and it gives Jackson a chance to either hand the ball off or keep it in his own hands and keeps it off the ground. Pitching the ball is dangerous on the goal line.
21-14, the Owls on top early in this fourth quarter. Let's check in now with Lewis Johnson.
Well, Beth, the uniforms that both teams are wearing today are a subtle way for them to say thank you to the Armed Forces of the United States. If you take a look at Rice, they've got that slick helmet on, and it's only worn for special occasions. The first time was a 10-year anniversary of 9/11. That was a blue helmet with the red, white, and blue R. Today, they've added the stripe for the Armed Forces Bowl, but only worn on special occasions. And then for Air Force, you see the jerseys. They've got B-2 Spirit and F-22 Raptor. One of the players told me before the games they've chosen those two planes because they are the biggest, and I bet the baddest, fighters in their arsenal. The F-22, the biggest fighter, and the B-2, the biggest bomber. And so again, this is their way to show respect to all the armed forces from here and around the world as we wrap up this season. But slick uniforms. But I'm wondering how they are for you guys to look up there and not have the names. How fun is that?
Well, plenty of stars and stripes on both sides. And the nod to the B-2 Spirit as well as the F-22 Raptor. And also a special sign there, the DW, the Academy Registrar, Dean Wilson, battling cancer for the third time and fighting the good fight. Best wishes from the Air Force family and certainly from all of us here at the Armed Forces Bowl. That Dean will be pressing on in his fight against cancer, and the Academy thinking about him here this afternoon. Into the end zone for the touchback on the kickoff. A 7-point Rice lead, and here is Reese Davis.
All right, Beth, get you up to date on what's going on the other networks. On ESPN2, North Carolina's jumped on top at 20th-ranked UNLV, 17-6. And on the Longhorn Network, potentially a great day for the Owls. They're up in football in our game. The Owls have a 5-point lead early on Texas in basketball on the Longhorn Network.
Well, it could be a big day for Rice Athletics. Leading Texas in basketball, they lead Air Force here by a touchdown. Connor Dietz and the Falcons back out there. Trying to regain a little bit of the offensive magic that Cale Pearson provided for them in the second quarter. And they had a 14-7 lead. And the pitch will go nowhere. Good pursuit once again defensively for the Owls. And Paul Porras, their cat.
That's a nice play by Porras, playing the cat position, which is sort of a hybrid linebacker spot, 190 pounds. Does a nice job of playing off the quarterback and goes and gets the pitch man and tackles the running back.
Dietz looking to throw, and the completion across the middle. A short gain. That was number 85, Marcus Hendricks, the sophomore out of Folsom, California, just his seventh reception of the season. Air Force only throws on average about 11 passes per game. They've thrown it 8 times in 51 plays today.
The problem is they've been in a lot of passing situations. You know, they've been in some third and longs, some second and longs, and here we have a third and long here. So you wonder, will they go pass or will they go back to the option where Dietz just hasn't looked very comfortable today?
Fakes the pitch, now looking to throw. And incomplete out near midfield. The coverage was good from Julius White.
Dietz has a guy wide open here out in the flat, but he has to throw the ball earlier, get it to him while he's wide open. He allows the safety White to recover on this ball, but the receiver's there. Great play call, had what you wanted, got to deliver the ball early and throw it a little harder.
Hunting unit back out there for Air Force, and Bryce Callahan back deep. It is away. They had tried a fake punt earlier in the game and failed to pick up the first down yardage, and the return out to the 45. So good field position again. 8 yards on the return, out close to midfield, and they're up a touchdown.
With the new year comes resolutions, when we resolve to stop snacking and slacking, resolve to start reading and running. This year, resolve to help someone else too. Resolve to support the American Red Cross, because the Red Cross provides hope, help, and compassion, not only during disasters, but every day. Resolve to do something that means something. Support the Red Cross before the new year. Visit redcross.org today.
Progressive Claims, this is Flo.
I need you. I feel so alone.
But you're not alone.
I knew you'd come.
Like I could stay away.
You know I can't do this without you.
You'll never have to.
You're always there for me.
Get you a rental car.
Selfies, an umbrella.
Fall in love with Progressive's claim service.
Scion has been helping people follow their dreams for nearly 10 years. If you've already started turning your passion into your profession, we can help you take it to the next level. Submit your business plan and other materials to our Motivate program. You could be set up with industry experts, a Scion, and $10,000 for your business. It's what's inside that moves us. What moves you? Learn more at scion.com/motivate.
Bridgewater and the Big East champs take on one of the nation's best defenses and the Gators' relentless rushing attack. The All-State Sugar Bowl, Louisville, Florida. Coverage begins Wednesday at 8 on ESPN.
Capital One Bowl Week continues today with games for you across ESPN and ESPN2, including Navy and Arizona State at 4 o'clock. It's the Kraft Fight Hunger Bowl. Then at 6:45. The Valero Alamo Bowl, Texas and Oregon State. And at 10:15 Eastern, TCU and Michigan State in the Buffalo Wild Wings Bowl on ESPN, ESPN2, and live on your Watch ESPN app. Air Force in the second half, 4 possessions, just 1 first down, unable to move it effectively. Rice, on the other hand, a couple of TDs under the direction of Dreyfus Jackson, and a career day for Jordan Taylor through the air. He's got a couple of touches. And Rice, after the punt, Jackson, they give right up the middle. Peterson, still on his feet, inside the 15, to the 10, out of bounds at the 6-yard line. First and goal, Rice. 48 yards on the
jaunt.
That's nice blocking by the Rice offensive line. And then the respect that you have to give Jackson to keep the ball. Because if he keeps the ball, he gets around in. So the defensive end has to commit to taking the quarterback, opens up the holes in the middle. And that's a big running play for this Rice offense.
Peterson staying in the game. Working out of the pistol, now stepping alongside Jackson. And a false start here on the Owls.
False start. Offense. Number 74. It's a 5-yard penalty. First down.
48 yards on the run for Turner Peterson, the former quarterback. Season long for him on the game, and the longest play of the day. We've also seen him been used today in a couple of plays as the Wildcat, or the Owlback, as Rice likes to refer to it. Air Force showing blitz, and they're bringing it. Jackson's pass, that maybe got tipped at the line.
Yeah, I think Means did a nice job of getting in the passing lane. Even if he didn't get his hand on the ball, he affected the throw, and Jackson realized he either had to throw it over him, which then it just sailed out of bounds.
Just the fourth incompletion for Jackson. He's 12 for 16, 187 yards on in relief today. His favorite target of the afternoon, Jordan Taylor, to the top of the screen. Jackson will look the other way, throw into the end zone, overthrows Murphy, and it's third and goal.
That's a player that Jackson would like to have back. If he throws this to the inside, he has a touchdown. And there's Taylor, his favorite receiver on the day, runs a little short route versus soft coverage. Very easily could have gotten a completion out to the right side.
Taylor again goes right to the top of the screen. McGuffey slotted left. Jackson calling his own number all the way, and the push forward to the 5-yard line. And it's fourth and goal.
And I think offense coordinator Coach Reagan decided, let's play this safe. At least let's get a field goal out of this situation. Make it a two-score game. Let's not take our chances. The young quarterback, he's a backup, played extremely well, but don't put him in a situation where it's a third and long going into the end zone when we have a chance to go up two scores.
Boswell 0 for 1 on the day. He actually made the 52-yarder, but Air Force had called a timeout before the snap, and then he missed it on the one that really counted. And a chip shot here for Boswell that is good. 24 to 14. The second half resurgence continuing for the Rice Owls.
Buy one, get three is back at Joseph A. Bank. Buy any suit, sport coat, or outerwear. Get three more absolutely free, including signature suits, sport coats, and leather jackets. That's four for the price of one. Expand your wardrobe or split the deal with friends and family. Mix and match any suit, sport coat, or outerwear. Buy one, get three free now. Most stores open at 9 a.m. through Saturday at Joseph A. Bank.
Capital One presents Capital One Bowl Impact Performances. January 1st, 2002, Tennessee's Casey Clawson wins the old-fashioned quarterback showcase, throwing for a whopping 393 yards, including two touchdown strikes to Kelly Washington, a 64-yard score to tight end Jason Witten, and 10 straight completed passes in the second half in the Vols' 45-17 win over Michigan. For more great Capital One Impact performances, tune into the Capital One Bowl January 1st on ABC.
Scion has been helping people follow their dreams for nearly 10 years. If you've already started turning your passion into your profession, we can help you take it to the next level. Submit your business plan and other materials to our Motivate program. You could be set up with industry experts, a Scion, and $10,000 for your business. It's what's inside that moves us. What moves you? Learn more at scion.com/motivate.
Hey.
You really like the sweater.
I love it.
Hi, I'm Victor Cruz. As an athlete who's done commercials, I know a thing or two about bad acting. And that was some bad acting. Why don't we return this for some approved gear from Foot Locker?
Awesome.
I felt that. Did you feel that?
ESPN College Football, the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl, is brought to you by Bell Helicopter, on a mission to support America's warfighters. The Capital One Cash Rewards Card with a 50% annual bonus. And Toyota Scion. See your local Scion dealer.
Bell Helicopter Textron here in Fort Worth, manufacturing commercial and military helicopters, including the Zulu, the Yankee, the Osprey, and the Kiowa Warrior. And we are back here at the Armed Forces Bowl. 17 unanswered points here for Rice against an Air Force offense that has sputtered since the second quarter. And now the Owls are on top 24-14. Outgaining Air Force by 186 yards this half. Anthony LaCrosse going to bring it out of the end zone. Staying on his feet out to the 19. Here's Lewis Johnson.
Hey, Beth, I'm an aviation nut, so I slipped out of the stadium because I wanted to see all the helicopters that Bell is showing off here. Look over there. That is the Cobra attack helicopter, but this one right here is my favorite. This is old school. It's a Bell helicopter from back in 1972, a Huey, already set up here for combat missions. Look at this big gun they have on it. And you know my dream is to get in this thing and fly it, so I'm going to do that. And I may not be back, all right? Maybe the fourth quarter. We'll see. Here we go.
Lewis Johnson is a fast learner in the pilot's seat, enjoying all the festivities around the Armed Forces Bowl, and a big thank you to all the American servicemen and women around the world. For the Air Force Academy, they have gone back to Cale Pearson at quarterback. They tried out Dietz in the first half, unsuccessful moving this offense. They went to Pearson for four drives. They scored a couple of touchdowns. He could not move them early in the third. They go back to Dietz for a couple of drives, ineffective again. So Pearson returns. And a hello, how you doing right there from Cameron Nawasu. Laying the wood on Pearson.
I'm not sure that Pearson feels comfortable pitching the ball. That was a play where he probably should have pitched. He's tucked it a number of times and just turned up where the pitch may have been there for him.
Pearson fakes it a couple of times. Now looking for the deep ball. He's got a man behind the defense, and he overthrows Drew Coleman. Let's check into the studio. Reese Davis.
All right, Beth, weather permitting, you might see this fella make some big pass plays like the one that would just miss connection. There's an hour game. Ryan Nassib, top 12 in the country in explosive pass plays. West Virginia and Syracuse coming up in the New Era Pinstripe Bowl.
Thank you, Reese. He might have a hard time finding clear airspace in that one with the snow falling in New York City at Yankee Stadium.
Rice's goal defensively to slow down this Air Force offense was to keep them off schedule, not allow them to gain good yards on first and second down. They've done a pretty good job. We've seen a number of third and longs here today, and here's another one. Let's see if Pearson can convert.
Pearson with the pitch, and a nice play coming up from the secondary. Phillip Gaines taking the legs out from underneath the runner, and here comes the fourth down.
Gaines is their best cover corner. But here, playing the run, when you play Air Force, you've got to be able to play the run at corner. Shuts down the edge. Again, assignment football. His assignment, take out the running back, makes a nice open field tackle.
Just two first downs in this second half for Air Force as Rice has clamped down. Callahan with the fair catch just inside his own 30-yard line. 9:27 to play. Well, Capital One Bowl Week has three games for you on New Year's Eve. It's NC State Vanderbilt in the Franklin American Mortgage Music City Bowl. Then Tulsa and Iowa State at the AutoZone Liberty Bowl. And the nightcap, LSU and Clemson in the Chick-fil-A Bowl. Capital One Bowl Week Monday on ESPN and the Watch ESPN app.
How about that Iowa State-Tulsa game? Looking forward to that one?
I'm looking forward to that. We'll be in Memphis bringing in the new year. That's a rematch of a season opener that Iowa State won. Tulsa with the 10-win season looking for some revenge. And another quarterback here for Rice. It's Michael Poynter, the rarely used senior from Arlington, Texas. He's actually a junior, but he's going to go ahead and graduate. He's got a great job lined up. And the players and the coaching staff all love Michael Poynter, and they wanted to give him a chance to get in there for a snap, and the youngster does. And a nice moment for him and the Rice Owls. Making memories, and then right back to the visor and the headset.
Couldn't let him throw a pass.
Good water cooler material, Joey, 5-10 years from now for Michael Poynter. Playing in a bowl game. And if things continue to go like this, playing in a win for the Rice Owls. They have been dominant in this second half. One of the big reasons why ball security after they had three fumbles in that second quarter. And kudos for Poynter now signaling in the next play.
I think he's over there telling Coach, come on, Coach. Yeah.
One more time.
One more.
That's the starter, Taylor McCarrick, over there on the right with the hat on and the street clothes and the towel draped over his arm. Third down here for Rice. Dreyfus Jackson throwing to Jordan. And the catch for the first down. Is there any kind of hierarchy, by the way, Joey? Do you want to be the guy that's sending in the signal, or is it fun to be the decoy signal or sometimes, or how does that work?
I think it'd be more fun to be the decoy signal. You can just come up with anything you want. I mean, you can just signal any old thing, have fun. You could be signaling your parents at home if you want.
We were disappointed that nobody had a board on the sideline with yours or my faces on it this year, as some of the schools have started to use now for their signals.
We'll work on that for next season. I agree with you.
Maybe when we're on the radio at the Liberty Bowl. Turner Peterson with the carry. He had that big run, the 48-yarder. Earlier in this second half for Rice. That offensive line able to open up some running room.
And part of the problem with the struggling Air Force offense is it's keeping their defense on the field a long period of time. And these guys are undersized. I mean, they're 240, 250, 260 in that defensive line. And they're getting pushed on all day long and on the field so long, they have got to be getting worn down.
Already over 31 minutes of possession for Rice. They are second in the country in time of possession. We've still got just under 7 minutes still to go as they pick up another first down.
And you can see how many guys from Air Force's defense is on the ground on this run play. You can see they look tired. They look worn down. They're not moving as well as they did early in this game.
Rice also runs close to 80 plays per game. They're already up to 70. And appear to be quite content to just keep running the football and running down the clock. Jackson tried for a deep hit. Incomplete. Intended for Jordan Taylor. How about his day? 8 catches, a career high, 119 yards. He's got a couple of touchdown catches. And he's just a sophomore. In fact, the bulk of this Rice team returns. They only have 4 senior starters.
And Taylor just had to let Jackson know, throw it up in the air, throw it to my back shoulder. That's when the height advantage is an advantage. If he throws it low and inside, then 5'8 Chris Miller can go get it.
Jackson wrapped up and thrown to the deck by Austin Nicholas. And a timeout called by Air Force, their first. Trying to save some time. They've got some ground to make up.
Scion has been helping people follow their dreams for nearly 10 years. If you've already started turning your passion into your profession, we can help you take it to the next level. Submit your business plan and other materials to our Motivate program. You could be set up with industry experts, a Scion, and $10,000 for your business. It's what's inside that moves us. What moves you? Learn more at scion.com/motivate.
Hershey's Drops. A lot of Hershey's happiness in little drops of milk chocolate and cookies and cream. Pure Hershey's.
Show me the Carfax.
We've got receipts from the previous owner.
Whoa.
At a car wash.
Tire shine.
You want to see the accidents and service records reported to Carfax and a price based on the car's history.
Show me the Carfax.
Ask your dealer or go to Carfax.com.
Now playing on DirecTV Cinema.
Fast porn.
Hanging.
How did you know with your face buried in that?
It's called multitasking.
You know too much about baseball to be a lawyer.
It's a long story.
I'd like to hear it.
I don't want to tell it.
Coming in?
You are crazy. Spending every waking moment with my dad watching baseball. Those were the best seats in the house.
Trouble with the Curve. Movies start at Channel 125.
A fight right here.
It's the one-shot knockout ability of Junior Dos Santos.
Now is my time. I'm gonna knock him out.
Big shot! That was a statement.
I want to be champion again. I'm gonna finish this fight.
Unbelievable!
For the UFC Heavyweight Championship.
It's gonna be a war out there.
Is available live anytime, anywhere on your computer, tablet, or smartphone at WatchESPN.com as well as the Watch ESPN app. Happy holidays here in Fort Worth, Texas. The Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl, Amon G. Carter Stadium. Newly renovated, a spectacular site. And a lot of military family and friends on hand. A 24-14 Rice lead, 6:09 to go. It's 3rd and 9, and the Falcons need a stop. Bringing the blitz, Means trying to get to Jackson instead. He throws it deep for McGuffey. Has it in at the 10. Acrobatic catch for Sam McGuffey in 35 yards. Their sixth pass today from Dreyfus Jackson. Over 20 yards.
And again, when Jackson has a chance to stand in the pocket, he delivers a pretty nice ball. Not sure what Lindsay, the safety, was looking at there. McGuffey's running right at him. No reason to let him get behind you, but he did, and Jackson delivered a strike.
Up around the 7-yard line. Second and goal. Rice putting up points on 3 of their last 4 drives and now sustaining here. With 5:31 to go. Big turnaround for the Owls. Trying to ice this one away against the Falcons in what has been dubbed the Battle of the Birds. You've got Rice, the great horned owl. They like to hunt at night, and I don't know if it's TMI, but they ingest all parts of their prey. Oof. And then, of course, the falcon likes to hunt at day and uses those talons to catch their prey.
Never really think of owls like that. You think of owls as this is what you think about when you think about an owl.
Yeah.
Guess they ingest the whole thing, huh?
Apparently. Nothing goes to waste. Yeah, it's a recyclable prey. Mutual of Omaha's Wild Kingdom has broken out here during Capital One Bowl Week. Second and goal. Jackson's got Ross in the backfield with him. Ross inside the five, down to the three. Alex Means with another tackle. As that clock will now stop due to the second Air Force timeout. 5:26 to play. And that Falcon defense running out of time and real estate. So with the timeout, third and goal for the Rice Owls. Beth Mowens along with Joey Galloway. Lewis Johnson also with us. We think he's returned from his helicopter ride from earlier in the second half. What a big turnaround, Joey, coming out of the locker room after Rice had fumbled the ball late in that first half in scoring territory, and that didn't faze them all in the third.
Both teams were playing with their backup quarterbacks, and it's going to be interesting to see who played better in the second half, and Jackson clearly has come out for Rice and played a terrific second half so far, has moved the team, has managed the ball, managed the game well, and taken care of the football most importantly.
And Rice defense has done a terrific job of shutting down that option attack in this second half. Trailed 14-7 heading into the locker room, and it's been all Owls here in the second, led by Jackson. McGuffey slot left. Taylor goes to the top of your screen. Now third and goal. Jackson keeps, and he won't get there. Fourth down. Ran right into Austin Nicholas.
Nice play by Nicholas. This is a very tired Air Force defense standing up here on the goal line, forcing a fourth down. Interesting call here by Rice. Interesting call to see if they would want to go for this in this situation. A touchdown here may put this game out of reach.
Fourth and goal. Jackson under center. Play clock is down to five. And they will let the clock run down.
Delay again. On the offense, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
Each side has had a bit of a different situation on a fourth down where they didn't even get the quarterback to the line to try and bark some signals to draw the defense off.
I think he got one signal in there. He got one hut in there real quick. I think they was in a situation where they didn't want to rush into anything. Mm-hmm. The 5 yards doesn't hurt them, so just line up, take the five, and then we'll kick a field goal.
25-yard attempt here for Boswell. Just does sneak it inside the upright. A 13-point lead, but that means a couple of Air Force scores and PATs, and they can still win it. But the offense needs a big turnaround.
He had the perfect pitch.
This lease gives us the right to drill on your land.
You could be a millionaire.
But he never expected a fight.
I work for a small environmental company.
Hey, get my friend a granola bar.
I think you have what it takes.
Oh, to beat you? Yeah.
Critics are raving. Promised Land is fantastically entertaining. Matt Damon is terrific.
We're a $9 billion company. Do you know what we're capable of?
Do you?
4 stars. It's one of the best pictures of the year from the director of Good Will Hunting.
What is going on here?
Steve!
Promised Land. Rated R.
All right, now that you're part of Junior Motorsports, let's see what you can do.
You know, on second thought,
know something you might be perfect at.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
File your federal return for only $9.95 with TaxSlayer.com.
ProjectLuna.com.
Red Lobster is surprising real people with our new 15 under 15 menu.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my gosh, this looks amazing.
15 entrees under $15. It's our new mainstays, like chicken with wine sauce or bacon wrapped shrimp. Try 15 under 15 and see food differently.
I'm Sergeant Major of the Army, Ray Chandler. Gene and I want to wish all of our soldiers a very happy holiday season.
And warmest holiday greetings to our spouses, family members, and professional civilians. Ray and I also send you our very best wishes for a healthy and prosperous new year.
At this special time, please remember our deployed comrades and keep them and their families close in your thoughts and prayers. Thank you for your unwavering service and sacrifice.
Army strong.
And we would echo those sentiments. Thank you, and a special shout out to the U.S. military around the nation, around the world. Here at the Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl, 20 unanswered points for the Rice Owls. They have held Air Force in the second half to just 2 first downs and 57 yards of total offense. But there is still a glimmer of hope, a couple of touchdowns, and Air Force can still win it. But they would have to find a spark for their offense here. Perhaps the special teams can do it. Now to the 24-yard line goes Lacoste, cut down there. And let's see who comes out at quarterback for Air Force. We have seen both Connor Dietz and Cale Pearson. And it looks like Pearson, number 2, will head back out there. Pearson had to throw it in a hurry. Had Cody Bauer right in his face.
The problem with this Air Force offense, because they want to run the ball so much, when you get down by 2 scores late in the fourth quarter and you force yourself into passing situations, you don't have a lot of plays for this kind of situation.
They've only thrown it 11 times all day. In fact, they were trying to run it there. And Pearson maybe got a yard. Christian Covington with the tackle.
Defensively,
it's a team that runs it about 84% of the time, Joey.
And defensively, the defensive backs will stay back now. The linebackers will stay back now. So the play-action passes won't be very effective in this situation.
Third down, Pearson. Intercepted. Pass picked off by Paul Porras at the 36-yard line. Junior out of Scottsdale, Arizona. And the Rice defense gets the turnover.
Pearson falling away, delivering a pass to the sideline late. That's a tough ball to throw. Not many guys are going to complete that ball. Interception for Porras, team's leading tackler. I mean, he's played well here today and now gets interception late in this game.
Rice will take over under 4 minutes to go. And here comes the Owls' ground game. The handoff to Turner Pearson. 8 carries, 74 yards for Pearson. Ross, 57 yards and a touchdown. 213 yards on the ground for Rice. They have outrushed Air Force, the second best running team in the country.
And you can see this defensive line is just worn out. They don't have anything. They're coming off the ball not very effectively, not stopping the running back in the hole. They just look worn out.
Jackson gives it to Eddington. Short game. We'll bring up third and a couple. This offense has moved the ball so well in the second half. The defense has shut down the Air Force attack, holding them to what stands right now as a season low 214 yards of offense, 166 rushing. That's about half of what they average during the year. Some movement from Rice up front.
False start, offense, number 55, 5-yard penalty, third down.
And what looks like a good problem to have heading into spring ball, Joey, you've got not one, but two good and two proven quarterbacks now. And Taylor McCarg, the junior, and Dreyfus Jackson, the redshirt freshman, replacing McCarg out with the head injury and has done a terrific job. 20 unanswered points here for the Owls.
It's going to be interesting moving forward. And Coach Bailiff is going to have to make a decision, because you know, watching Jackson here today, he's played well. He's looked very athletic and shows a pretty strong arm when he has cut the ball loose.
Of course, on the other sideline, career coming to an end for that young man right there. No longer a cadet. Second Lieutenant Connor Dietz. 60 days of leave that will start tomorrow, and then off to MacDill Air Force Base in Tampa. He will actually follow in the footsteps of his coach, Troy Calhoun.
Nice. That's a 30-second timeout.
Does not want to be a pilot. He'll get into logistics down in Tampa. Down to the field now with Lewis.
All right, Beth, well, it will not be long before the officials here will give out this official trophy, and they believe it is the most unique trophy in all the bowl games, and here's why. It is made from some of the battlefield materials from Iraq. Take a look at the football here. It has some of the tanks, a tank shell melted into the football, incredibly heavy. And then the logo right here, it has pieces of an attack helicopter in the inside melted there, so awfully unique. So it won't be long for, it looks like Rice may get it. And yes, as the sign says behind us, we do at ESPN want to thank every soldier who has protected our nation. Won't be long. Beth?
Thank you very much, Lewis. You can catch the trophy ceremony, by the way, coverage for you on ESPN3 following the conclusion of today's game. They were down 14-7 rather at halftime. All Rice here in the second half, 27-14 the lead.
What's interesting is Lewis said that they think that's the only one of its kind. I don't know where you get some attack helicopter equipment to mix into your trophy.
Jackson. Five and into the end zone. Touchdown for Jordan Taylor. That's his third of the day. Chris Miller. Nine catches, 153 yards, three touchdowns, and the PAT is no good as the Rice offense goes over 500 yards on the day. 26 unanswered points under the direction of Dreyfus Jackson here in the second half. And it all started really with the turnover at the end of the first half.
Yeah, and besides the ball slipping out of his hand for the turnover, he has played a tremendous game. He's taken hits. He stood in the pocket. He's delivered strikes. He's thrown the ball to Taylor, his big receiver, to his back shoulder where no one else can get it. He's delivered balls downfield to McDuffie. Been very impressed with the backup quarterback, Jackson, with his athleticism and his ability to manage the game.
Dreyfus Jackson, our Capital One player of the game, he throws 15 for 21, 264 yards. Finding Jordan Taylor twice, 34 yards on a touchdown pass, 22 yards on another one. And then Taylor had the 16-yard touchdown reception from McHarg in the first half. And what a day for the redshirt freshman quarterback, on in relief. And a big win for David Bailiff and the Rice Owls. How about the turnaround for Coach and his young team? They started out the season 1-5, and there were questions about his future. And boy, have they answered them in kind. They're going to end the season 6-1 with a bowl victory. And almost everybody coming back next year. And they may have just forced the turnover on the kickoff. They do. Rice football.
We talked about the turnover issues for this Air Force team. They come out here today and they've had a few. Here, this one at the end of the game doesn't matter much, but it's still a turnover and something that in the future they're going to have to fix.
Tremendous offensive effort in the second half. Kudos to the defense, too, by the way, for Rice and defensive coordinator Chris Thurman. They hadn't seen the option all year, and they have shut down Air Force with the exception of the two scoring drives in the second quarter. As Michael Pointer returns at quarterback here to take another snap to close out his career.
If I'm Pointer, I take this snap. Run around the end.
No, you wouldn't.
Get one in. I mean, this is the end of his career. Couple snaps here. What are you going to do? Suspending?
Well, you know, it's a respect thing. Yeah.
The owl is a bird of prey. You showed us that earlier, that the owl is definitely a bird of prey. Let me take my chances. They took him out?
That's his curtain call.
Come on.
He wanted to give the fans a chance to give Pointer a curtain call.
Come on.
Before he heads out into the working world.
I guess so.
Passing up on a year of eligibility next year. As we talked about, Rice and Air Force, true student athletes. Amongst the best and the brightest. And the Owls getting the better of the Falcons here this afternoon. The Bell Helicopter Armed Forces Bowl, the 10-year anniversary, and it's the Rice Owls celebrating a win over Air Force 33-14, just their second bowl win in the last 57 years, and both of those coming under the direction of David Bailiff. Second half, 26 unanswered points for Rice. They held the Falcons' attack to just 58 yards in that second half. And Dreyfus Jackson, a big day, couple of touchdown passes. Jordan Taylor, three touchdown catches. And a defense that shut out Air Force in the second half. Coach Bailiff now standing by with Lewis Jackson.
All right, Beth, thanks very much. Well, Coach, you started the season 1-5. How amazing is this finish here, winning a bowl game?
You know what? They just never quit believing. They work harder every time they came to practice. Had great senior leadership. And, you know, I also want to say what an amazing job that Coach Calhoun does at that Air Force Academy. Those kids are amazing. They played hard. We're thrilled with this win, but they sure made us earn it.
Well, you were dashed some adversity. You lost Taylor McCarg, and then Dreyfus Jackson stepped in. Talk about the way he played and carried you out.
I tell you what, how unbelievable is that? That you know, Taylor goes out in the second, and Dreyfus comes in, and I don't believe we've had any turnovers in the second half.
Right.
And that was our nemesis in the first half. We just kept shooting ourselves in the foot. So absolutely thrilled. I thought our coaches did an amazing job with their game plans offensively, defensively, but really, really proud of the way Dreyfus Jackson stepped up.
And how about the wide receiver that he was throwing to?
Yeah, Jordan Taylor, he didn't have a bad day either, did he? That was a lot of fun watching these young men compete. And once again, know how honored we are. And proud of those Air Force Academy kids for when they graduate, what they do for this country. What a great bowl experience this was for Rice. And, you know, we're going to go get that trophy, and we're thrilled.
Coach, congratulations on your victory today.
Thank you, Lou!
All right, Beth.
David Bailiff excited about a Rice win, and why not? They're second in 57 years. And Gatorade bath, well worth it. On a chilly, sunny day here in Fort Worth, Texas, a memorable one for the Rice Owls. For those of you wanting to see the trophy presentation, turn to ESPN3 for all the post-game ceremony. Coming up next, the New Era Pinstripe Bowl from a snowy New York City. Now let's get you to the studio. Reese Davis, Mark May, and Lou Holtz.
All right, Beth, and it is a snowy day. Dana Holgorsen leading West Virginia and against Syracuse. The Orange beating West Virginia the last 2 years, of course, until West Virginia moved to the Big 12. Those two both members of the Big East. That is coming up in just a few moments. But an impressive performance by Rice, most notably from Dreyfus Jackson. You always want the quarterback, the backup quarterback, to prepare as if he's a starter. He not only looked like a starter, he looked like a star with the way he played against Air Force.
And in the second half, didn't turn the ball over. And here is very impressive. Not only running their offense, but throwing the ball vertically. I thought that was impressive in this game. But I was also impressive with their defense. Their defense held Air Force to a season low 214 yards. But more importantly, half their average per game running the football, 166 yards. Their front four did a tremendous job of getting penetration into the Air Force offense.
Back. Well, you had to be happy and impressed for Rice. This means they won six of their last seven games, even to get into the bowl and then to win it. And how disappointing it is for Air Force. For the first time since 2005, they lost to both Army and Navy. They lost a bowl game. They also had a losing season. And that becomes very disappointing. However, they're great young men. They'll bounce back from it.
New Era Pinstripe Bowl was going to be our next bowl. West Virginia and Syracuse. It's a snowstorm coming in the Northeast. They've been working to get the snow away from the playing surface. We're going to see some of the offensive stars for both teams, many of whom will hear their name called on draft day coming up this spring. Todd McShay, some of the guys you want to keep an eye on in our game.
First of all, you got to be excited anytime you get to watch these wide receivers of West Virginia. Tavon Austin and Stedman Bailey have been getting it done at a very high level for a couple years now. Austin's the better of the two, even though he's a little bit smaller than Bailey and probably not as consistent catching the football. He is one of the